Canon 1.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2, W29ABB, WIBC, HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan.
Hey, John boy.
I'm telling you straight, it's my way or the highway. So anybody wants to walk, do it now.
Hey, everybody, we're all going to get laid.
And again, it's picked up. It's Darius Leonard. A pick six for the Maniac. Touchdown, I-N-D-Y. Yes, sir.
Sabonis down the lane with authority.
John, I have never been better. To be on the air with you here in Indianapolis, a place where so many of my dreams have come true.
The Ride with JMV on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Hey, welcome in. Busy day. Man, we got a couple of Colts draft selections coming up on the show a little bit later on. Sean Davis, the safety out of Florida, was a fifth rounder for the Colts. He's going to drop in here coming up a little bit after 4 o'clock today. Will Fries, guard, Penn State, seventh rounder, 248 overall, is somewhere in the neighborhood of 430 today, too. That, Bowen coming up in the 5 o'clock hour. Bobby Marks of ESPN, he is the front office expert, former NBA front office guy, because we're going to have to go over hard and fast the ridiculousness, the absolute ridiculousness that the Pacers are right now. And that's just beyond the play. You know, beyond the play. Now, you watched him the other night, couldn't guard you. Terrible. Giving up over 150 points and losing. All right, you can look at that and you can go, obviously, you got to make offseason changes. You can look at that and go, obviously, you don't have guys out there. But here's what I'm sick and tired of. I don't know about anybody else out there, but I am so sick and tired of the drama. I am sick and tired of the soap opera. And the problem that you have is, you know, basically the past couple of years, that's really all you've had to go on. It seems like there's been a hell of a lot more than that than there has been actual compelling basketball. And that is problematic. Because no matter what you think, because I know exactly what some of you out there are thinking right now. You're going, hey, what this does, it stirs your show and it gets people interested. Baloney, it does. It pushes them away because people want to talk good things about the teams they care about and follow. They want to be positive about it. You know, most people aren't built like some of the jackasses you're thinking about that just want to complain about everything. And especially that of around here. And especially since you haven't had a lot to really embrace. All right, so they made the postseason. Fantastic. I mean, when was the last time you really got to embrace the fun of the Pacers? I mean, really, a longer-term embrace, not just a fleeting moment here or there. You know, not the 50-plus that T.J. Warren put up on the board against Philly inside the bubble down in Orlando to make up the rest of last year. I'm talking about just a longer embrace, not just a moment or two, not a flash. What, Oladipo's first season here, I'm assuming, was it? That's my guess. All right, it's one thing to me. It's one thing to look at your team and to bring in a coach because you clearly listen to the players, which is, this is exactly, I guess, where you end up if you listen to the players. But that's one thing. And one thing to be injured and one thing to make just a myriad of excuses about that everybody's going to digest. But, man, I'm so sick of putting up with this crap. We had to go through this same soap opera baloney last summer. And hell, we all blamed that on Vic. Maybe it's not Vic's fault. You know, at some point, Kevin Pritchard needs to put a tent over the circus. Seriously. I mean, why does this stuff, why is there such a soap opera more often than not? Is it just a coincidence? So you're going to tell me that this whole Wojnarowski thing, and by the way, I'll get to the other aspect of it in just a second, right? Because I'm going to give credit where credit is due, and that's exactly what I do. I'm not going to sit here and make fun of local people. Where are the local people? Where are the local people covering this and covering that? J. Michael talked about that a week and a half ago. But no flares were shot up around here. And then somebody just hands this on a silver platter, and I'll give it up to these dudes. These dudes work in covering a team that's really not that enjoyable to watch. And they do. They cover the team that's not that enjoyable to watch. You know what they get? I mean, a nugget here or there, and then somebody drops in this huge piece because you want the overall reaction. You want everybody's eyeballs on it. I do get the process, but the process sucks. It has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with them. I'd be pissed, too. If I were them, I wouldn't feel, and maybe they don't. I wouldn't hesitate at all to throw daggers at them then. Wherever that came from, if it was motivated by a player, if it was motivated by the front office, you know, whatever. I mean, this is everybody's fault, and then everybody's under the watchful eye of Kevin Pritchard. So, and I like Kevin, and you guys know that. I enjoy our conversations, but where have we not put in the finger at this point? Where have you not? I mean, you've pointed the finger everywhere else. Oh, it's been the coach's problem. Well, Nate's not a player's coach. New Nate is a player's coach. Everybody embraces that. He and Malcolm Brogdon, they talk all the time. They have a great relationship. Players like to play this way. They want a new era type of offense. They want somebody that's more directed for their style of play that they want to. Ah, well, Vic was a diva. Paul George was a diva. Oh, the Simons don't spend. We've been around every turn. I don't know where else you want to talk. I mean, when do we start talking about that? Either we start talking about that or you figure something out, because I'm sick of this. I'm sick of it. And I'm assuming a lot of you are also sick of it. This is really the only thing that has been consistent about this team over the past couple of years. The stinking soap opera. And I don't like them. I mean, if it had Hope running around on Days of Our Lives, you know, with the cleave hanging, whatever, I'd be all over that if I'm 14. But I'm not about it at 51. I want to see these guys put something together that's fun to watch. Now, I know we've all given, I've sat here too, I've given excuses. Oh, it's tough, and nobody wants to be here. So what are the motives for this? I mean, is it a player? And we'll get to the Wojnarowski tweets in just a second. I mean, everybody seems to think that this is motivated by a player. This is motivated by Brogdon. You know, Brogdon is presidential with the team, and Brogdon, if you remember correctly, it was just 2 months ago where it was talked about how Brogdon calls Bjorkgren all the time. And is it Sabonis? We had J. Michael on, a week and a half ago, and he said some of the players weren't happy that, you know, the ball was always consistently going through Sabonis. No, it wouldn't be Sabonis. He's putting up the best numbers of his life. Is it Miles? Miles has a sore toe, but he's put up the best numbers. I mean, he was mentioned as defensive MVP for a while. Until he hurt his toe. And so who is it? Who is it with that organization that you can drop that nugget to Adrian Wojnarowski and turn things upside down and make this thing look like a clown show? Who's done that? Because it is a bad look. You can say what you want, but it is a bad look. It's one thing to give up, you know, 150-plus and 20-plus assists and rebounds to Russell Westbrook in that fashion, but it is completely different when you're talking about this. I mean, this was supposedly what the players wanted. This was supposedly a change of heart from Kevin Pritchard, because that's what the players wanted, going back on what he thought he was going to do and bringing McMillan back, and then going to Bjorkgren, because that makes sense. You're going to make everybody happy. Thus, these guys play better. These guys play harder. There's been fleeting evidence of that. So where's the problem here? Now, who decided to go ahead and spring that info? See, and that's the difference. That is the difference. I mean, if you're somebody and you wanted to unleash that on a moderate scale, and it's nothing against everybody that covers this team, but if you wanted to do that, then you would keep that thing local. But, man, you really wanted to make this hit the mark, or in this case, leave a mark. So you take that to the guy that everybody believes is the gospel as far as breaking NBA news. So there's got to be something larger behind it. There's got to be something more than, right? I mean, you don't have just a couple of hurt feelings that can easily be warmed over. It seems like when you take it to this level after that game, and I know some of you are suggesting, well, it's to get this team fired up for Sacramento. How? I admit that it may take a lot to get fired up for Sacramento, but that's what you want to do? I mean, how fired up do you have to? I mean, do you want to play a postseason game? Do you want to keep Assignment off your ass because they want this team in the postseason? Why would you unleash that right now and just embarrass everybody? It does. It embarrasses everybody. And believe me, you think I want to talk about this? Well, you're absolutely wrong, because I don't. I think this stinks. I think this is stupid. And I don't know why. If I'm Kevin Pritchard right now, and I know you're not going to justify the report or justify the rumors unless you're the one that unleashed it. Unless you're the one that's not happy about what you have brought in, unless you're believing that Brad Stevens is going to get canned in Boston and maybe you have an offseason opportunity there. I mean, I don't know what would make sense there, but unless you're that guy, I would certainly speak out on behalf of my team, the team that I put together, that has fallen apart. The team that I have questioned you put together, and I kind of wondered, well, wait a minute, you want to play that style? You really don't have. I've talked about this. I've called them and compared them to mismatched socks. It's like you have some good players. Like I get in my sock drawer and I've got some really good socks, but I got some socks that stink and got holes in it and they don't work. And that's the case here. They may work someplace else. They may work on somebody else's foot. My daughter may dig them. Oh, yeah, they're great, very comfortable. But for me, not so much. And that's kind of how this team is built. You want to play this way, you really don't have the personnel to play this way. And you sure as hell don't have the personnel to defend anyway, no matter what the defensive efficiency might tell you. Nothing, zero. All you got to do is watch it. I mean, I know everybody wants to go by the numbers, and there you go. We got to go by the numbers because we're all analytically driven these days. And listen, I don't have my head in the sand. I mean, I know you got to look at those, and we talk about them all the time. We're big on the PFF dudes, but there is something also to be said about the lost art of just watching something over and over again that does not seem to consistently work, and then wonder if it ever is. So, you know, again, normally, people in decision-making positions, especially in sports, you are not going to speak out with regard to a report and stoke the flames. But in this case, I mean, I don't know. Maybe you feel comfortable and not, because you feel nobody's paying a stinking amount of attention right now. But I'm tired of it. I mean, everybody blamed Oladipo on that fiasco last summer, and believe me, I mean, Vic was his own worst enemy because he surrounded himself with some knuckleheads. And now Vic's where he wants to be. Yeah, we blamed it. I blamed Paul George. So if crap like this continues to happen over and over and over again, how can you ignore it? I mean, either you're going to be a part of the solution or a part of the problem here if you're Kevin. I mean, something has to be done. I was trying to think about the goodwill. I mean, what is the good thing that comes out of this season? I know it's based inside of a pandemic and you don't have the normalcy whatsoever, but you're still playing, right? There's still pride in playing. I guess. I assume there's pride and participation. But, yeah, you know, where are the positives? Anybody got any positives? You might come up with one here or there, but it's going to make, I bet you not only it's going to take you a second to think about it, but you may end up having to debate yourself over it. And then you have this. And I don't know who did it. I don't know who did it from over there, but man, you're just making stuff worse. Making it worse. I mean, already, fans already looked at it the way that it was, and unfortunately, I still watch because I love basketball. There's no doubt about it. No, everybody's all over the NBA right now. I still watch it. Hell, I came home last night. Played a little bit of hoop, came home. I sucked last night, too. I'm probably salty because of that. I played a little bit of hoop, came home, watched that late-night game. About 12:30 or so in the morning. I love watching it, and I will always love watching it. I'm over. I'm sick and tired of the soap opera. I'm sick and tired of the drama. And the lone consistent part of this, the lone consistent piece of this has been Kevin. And maybe it's not his fault. But he's the only one that most people have not blamed at this point. So I'm ready to hear some stuff. I'm ready to hear some answers. I'm ready to hear some reasons. I mean, normally this Wojnarowski stuff is not overblown. I mean, normally it's on target. And I completely understand why you want to filter it out through him, because then you get the NBA world going, huh, all right. So while you do that for motivation against Sacramento, how much motivation do you need to play anybody after you take a beating and you give up 150-plus points the other night? You got to stir up a little drama for that? What are the motives here? I mean, the players decide that Sabonis is getting too much of the spotlight. I don't like it. Hey, listen, you know what we can do if we really wanted to, and if this was player-driven? We can poke holes in everybody's situation there, can't we? I mean, there's nobody that's not nearly untouchable there. The moment you can say, hey, well, this is what this guy does, you can also say, hey, well, this is what this guy sucks at doing. And this is what others have to make up for, the shortcoming of this guy, just as much. And really, you can do that throughout the organization if you want to right now. And listen, I like people. I've got friends over there. There's no doubt about that. But I'm sick of it. I am sick of it. I don't know about anybody else. I mean, I think people kind of used that last night as a joke. And, you know, everybody immediately reacts. You got to fire this and you got to fire that. I just put my hands up and went, I'll be damned. I mean, really? I mean, what knucklehead decided to unleash this right now? I'm trying to think, too, if it's player motivated, so does it take a player saying this to the loudest voice in the NBA and breaking news to get you, the fan base here, to understand that there are issues? All you got to do is watch. It doesn't take James Naismith to understand that there are some issues here. So why do it now? What is the motivation? Anybody have any theories? I mean, I've dropped some. I have some. Maybe it's faulty steering. I mean, we have blamed everybody. It's always been the players' fault, been the coach's fault. It's been the Simons' fault. I mean, it's about time. It's about time for President reigns some crap in, unless he's the one that dropped that nugget in. And I'm trying to think of, because you got to think of when you do something like you do a show where everybody listens and everybody wants to take part and has an opinion about. Because again, we deliver, and we also to you we give you the voice of those fans that are out there right now. So what would be his motivation if Kevin were the one organizationally to drop that nugget of info to Adrian Wojnarowski? What's the motivation? So you want to muddy up the waters here because you went from, you know, bringing one guy back to then getting rid of one guy and bringing a new guy in, you know, kind of bending over to the team right now because they wanted a player-oriented coach? I mean, why would you want to embarrass the organization? Because that's a bad look. I don't care what anybody says. Yeah, I'm not overblowing this. It is an extremely bad look. I mean, on the court, it was bad enough the other night. But at the very least, if you wanted to make excuses, what you could do is say, hey, they're injured. I mean, you could. Well, they're injured. You can't really excuse this. Man, I don't care where it comes from. This just embarrasses everybody. And if I were you, I'd be sick of it too. But seriously, I mean, double back for a moment and think in your own mind, when was the last time that you got to consistently embrace something with this team that was good? There have been moments, I'm not going to lie there, but when was the last time you got to embrace that? I mean, we know the last time you really got to embrace a winner, and I mean a playoff winner, a challenger in the postseason. I mean, Vic's first year here, it was fun as hell to watch, but it's not like it really moved the meter as far as deep run in the postseason is concerned. It has been a long time. There's been much more drama. It's been much more of a soap opera than I think any of us would want. And again, contrary to popular belief out there, I think drama and soap opera stuff sucks. And there's a point in time when you guys are tuned in and interested, but at some point you're going to go, man, I'm sick of hearing everybody complain about it, and you're going to bail. Listen, I've been around here long enough to know. I mean, there's a reason why you tune in more than anywhere else every day right here, is because you know I've been around here long enough to know, regardless of being in a locker room or whatever, screw that. All you're looking for is knowledge. All you're looking for is opinion. All you're looking for is to have a voice. I've been around here long enough to know that. And I feel you. I mean, I do. I feel you. You're tired of it, and I don't blame you. I mean, there comes a point in time too, right? And this is what we used a lot with IU basketball. There comes a point in time when you are worn out of pissing and moaning, and you just disconnect. And what's interesting about that is this season it made it, and I have focused on that a couple of different times, and I feel your pain. It would suck for me because I like watching the games. I always will like watching the games. I always do. But luckily, I still get it with DirecTV. Some of you don't have the luxury of just being able to turn on the television and get that game. Thus, with all that has been going down, with the lack of success on the floor, and now with this rise in drama off of it, you just disconnect altogether. And that is the worst part. That is the absolute worst. Now, that's much worse than missing some playoff formatted vision that the NBA has put together not to have teams tank. That is much worse. And we saw that. We made a point of that with IU basketball, and that's what happened. You say, you know what? I'm not even mad anymore. I'm just not going to watch. And we'll see where they go from here. Bobby Marks going to join me at the bottom of the hour. He's a former front office exec in the NBA. We always go to him with questions like this. I'm just kind of curious as to what, you know, unless it seems like it has to be a player, but what's the motivation beyond that? I mean, somebody trying to get a change, somebody didn't like how they're used. I'm just trying to think which guy on that team, if they were to unleash this, doesn't like how they're being used. Brogdon, you can shoot, you can dribble, and you don't have to play defense. I would embrace that every day. Yeah, that's the perfect basketball game for most of us. You can shoot, get the green light, you can dribble, and yeah, then you'll take a step left or a step right, and then by that point, there's a blow by with the person you're guarding, and you're off the hook. You know, I've already mentioned, you know, Miles was having, what, his best defensive season up until that point. Domas, numbers through the roof. Why would he? I mean, who else would be doing this on that team? Yeah, these other guys have a motivation. So now if you're, you know, if you're Pacers, you got to come up with what answers. I mean, what's Nate Bjork going to have to do? You know, to win back or to win over either the locker room or the front office or whomever he has clearly messed up. And believe me, it hasn't seemed like that there's been anything connectable between he and this team. I mean, it may have been early with the players, but as far as, you know, what he's trying to do and what they have right now, not so much. That's just the way that it feels to me. The tweet last night was this, and I'm assuming that most of you are involved in the conversation right now. Reddit: amid a year of difficulties with players and staff, Pacers coach Nate Bjorkman's future with the franchise is uncertain as the regular season nears a close. Sources tell ESPN the Pacers 30-34 and ninth place in the East. Bjorkman has work to do on relationships. He's let these guys do what they want. Why would they be pissed? Other than being de-pantsed in games by Russell Westbrook. But they didn't look too much like they cared in that game the other night, so why would they care now? So you have work to do on relationship with key players in the locker room. And has thus far shown a willingness within the organization to try to address those issues. Well, I mean, you would, because you don't want to get gassed. So, Kev, seriously, I know that it's not commonplace, and I know you're probably taking advice to the contrary, but somebody may want to speak to this at some point and not give everybody the same old lip service, because this soap opera crap has been much more prevalent and much more consistent than a high level of play for this team. It just has. That's my thoughts. We can dive into that, and I'm sure you guys have some thoughts on it as well at 239-1070. Email address is jmv@1070thefan.com. Email address jmv@1070thefan.com. We can also jump in on the lounge on YouTube Live if you want to do that as well. I mentioned Kevin Bowen's going to join us in the 5 o'clock hour. 405 for Will Fries? All right, I saw it now. Sean Davis is rescheduled. So we'll talk to the 7th round selection by the Colts coming up at 4:05. So did Sean Davis just like get the word that I was pissy today and decide to reschedule? I would too. I'd go, good Lord, I listened to this guy on the way in. All he's doing is whining. How about we reschedule? My man's got his underwear in a wad here. I think I'll reschedule. That's a savvy move. That's a veteran move for a rookie entering the NFL. Luke Bryan tickets to help brighten your day. I think it's August the 20th for that show, Ruoff Music Center. When you hear a Luke Bryan song, 5th caller will win those tickets. It's a Luke Bryan tickets a little bit later on. All right, Bobby Marks at the bottom of the hour. I'm going to see if he can help sift through where this team is right now and the myriad of issues. I guess what it comes down to, and certainly other than around here where you do care, But I guess it's moments like this where maybe you consider yourself fortunate that the rest of the NBA doesn't give a crap. But we around here is the reason why you have this show, the reason why I'm here and others on this station are here to speak to it because you care about it. The rest of the sports world, they don't give a big fat crap, but you do, and that's why we're here. And that's why we better always be here for you. You can't go to Spotify and go, oh, well, what do they think about this? That's why you should embrace this each and every day. Quick break and we'll return. Bobby Marks, ESPN front office insider, is going to join us coming up next.
At HeroLoan.com, we pay for the appraisal and can close your VA loan in as little as 14 days. Apply online today at HeroLoan.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
The odds have been posted for the Indy 500 at Bet Rivers. Hammer here for Indy's hometown sportsbook, Bet Rivers, Indiana. Make sure you have the app downloaded. Whether you have an Android or an iPhone, download Bet Rivers, Indiana. They are your home of betting on IndyCar, and you can bet on the Indy 500 right now. Bet Rivers, Indiana. Must be 21 and over, a resident of Indiana, and if you have a gambling problem, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
This morning, Jen woke up, made three breakfasts, did two loads of laundry, and one conference call. But she also saved $25. Because Jen uses a new innovation from Huntington called Money Scout. It analyzes Jen's checking account to find money that's not being used and moves it to her savings automatically. Learn more and enroll at Huntington.com/Money Scout. Huntington, welcome. Message and data rates may apply to text alerts. Money Scout is subject to eligibility, terms and conditions, and other account agreements. Member FDIC.
Hey, it's Rob Belushi from Bill S.'s Ford in Brownsburg. Some things are going back to the way they belong.
The race is back in May.
That's right, Brian, and we've got pole position on the best deals. Right now, the EcoSport Edge, Escape, and Explorer are all up to $9,000 off.
All May, save up to $9,000 on SUVs.
Brian is peeling out because we've never offered $9,000 off our best-selling SUVs.
EcoSport Edge, Escape, and Explorer. Epic! Burn rubber into Bill S.'s Ford and save big.
Want more? Trade or sell your car to us and we'll give you up to $2,000 more. With over 200 premium pre-owned vehicles, we have the best selection. And we drive you over the finish line with 99% financing approval.
We got the checkered flag on savings.
Brian, stop pouring milk on yourself. There's milk everywhere.
I just won this thing.
In the race to savings, our customers are the winners, Brian, and you need a pit stop and change out of those clothes. Finish first in SUV savings. All May, save $9,000 and get $2,000 more for your trade. Your key is waiting at Bill S.'s Ford in Brownsburg.
Don't spend more than you have to on your mobile service. Spectrum Mobile could save you up to 40% versus what you're paying now. And nationwide 5G is included in every data plan. Plus, Spectrum delivers the fastest overall speeds and has the most reliable mobile service, coast to coast, with no hidden taxes, fees, or contracts. Visit SpectrumMobile.com today. 40% savings based on a comparison of single-line comparable unlimited plans amongst major national carriers as of 1/27/2021. Fastest overall speed, most reliable, based on Nielsen speed test, latest FCC report, and route metrics.
You're no golf pro. You're just a guy trying to practice your swing without your back hurting. But you can get treatment for your back pain just like the pros do. Instead of going to your doctor first, start with Athletico Physical Therapy. With no prescription needed, their physical therapists find the source of your pain and start treating it before it gets worse. The same therapists who work with world-class athletes and elite golfers will work with you. No injuries. That's winning.
It all starts at Athletico Physical Therapy. Schedule your free assessment with Athletico.com. No prescription needed in most states.
Hey, it's JMV for LD Smith Plumbing at 317-284-9526. They're the absolute best, and one thing you don't want to live without is a battery backup on your sump pump. And right now, LD Smith Plumbing is offering a free primary sump pump with installation on a battery backup system in your home. 317-284-9526. That's LD Smith Plumbing. The best in following CDC recommended guidelines. For more info online, ldsmithplumbing.com today. Hey, JMV here. Back-to-back JMV is always really good for you. Let's do this, all right? Soccer scoreboard update brought to you by the Hometown Club, the Indy 11 Saturday, Carroll Stadium home opener, FC Tulsa in the house. Tickets available, Indy11.com. What do you got going on here right now? One afternoon, at least in this country affair, Chelsea 1, Real Madrid nothing, 32nd minute. Get you a final coming up a little bit later on, but I do want to remind you, you have the Indy 11 home opener, Carroll Stadium, Saturday, 7 o'clock, FC Tulsa, Greg Rakestraw on the call. You'll love it. Tickets available, Indy11.com right now.
The Ride with JMV.
Just an average guy with exceptional hair.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Sean Davis is rescheduled for tomorrow. No, not tomorrow. No time yet. There's no truth to the rumor that he heard that opening diatribe and just bailed, right? Nothing truth? I got you. Will Fries of Penn State, 405. Bowen's going to be in here coming up at the 5 o'clock hour. Hey, listen, I am going to get to Eric Fisher. Charles Leno, I'm not going to tell you I'm any expert offensive line evaluator, but Charles Leno doesn't miss any time, hasn't missed any time, and can you bring in a healthy player? Just bring in a healthy player, all right? Bring in a healthy player. I know that Chris has connections with Fisher, and connections always work because clearly the Colts rarely, if ever, go after anybody and bring them in unless there's a prior connection. But go with the healthy dude that's best ability in the past 7 years in Chicago has been availability. It doesn't seem that hard. I know. Tevi's healthy. Well, good for Tevi. Andy Moore, Automotive Group Hotline. Bobby Marks of ESPN, ESPN.com, the front office insider, joins us now. I'm a little bit pissy today because, frankly, Bobby, we've talked before. I'm sick and tired of this drama and soap opera crap going on around here. I really am. I mean, I know you've had to deal with it before, maybe not extended. We've gone through Paul George, Victor Oladipo, and now this. So help me out. With what Adrian Wojnarowski, your colleague at ESPN, tweeted about last night, where would you think the purpose would be served? Player, organizationally, I mean, what do you think is going on behind the scenes here to really put this team, I think, in a really bad look right now?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, anytime you have a turnover with a head coach and you go from, a guy like, Nate McMillan, who, had stability there, and then you go out and hire, a guy like Nate Bjorken, that's an indication, and it doesn't work out, and we'll see where this goes. I mean, that's kind of an indication from the front office as far as from a hiring skill standpoint. Like, I always say, like, you always get, one mulligan here. Like, when you go out and hire or fire a coach and, the person you hire. But, yeah, I mean, when you go out and if it doesn't work after 1 year, it sets your organization back a long time. I mean, there's teams like Sacramento that are continually spinning the wheels on head coaches, and you know, they haven't made the playoffs in, 15, 16 years here. So I think it's all across the board. I mean, I understand, like I said last night, like coaching in this league, 70% of it right now is about managing your locker room, developing relationships with your own players, where they can trust you. And then the other 30% is the X and O's and game planning. I mean, that's kind of where we are right now. And if you hire somebody that can't do that, then shame on you for hiring that person.
Well, I mean, and Kevin's the only guy that nobody's blamed around here, honestly. And I like Kevin a great deal.
Sure,
but
Kevin's done a great job.
Kevin's
done a good job with the. I understand. Hey, they've built in a post Paul George wasn't easy. They were able to make some good trades. They've had some good draft picks here. They've stayed competitive. They haven't bought them out. They've been decimated with injuries this year, and we all know about that. But at the end of the day, the person who does the hiring and then eventually does the firing, is kind of on the number one guy as far as where we're looking for answers from.
Completely agree. And he's the only one around here, as I mentioned, that hasn't taken the blame or hasn't been blamed for it. I mean, it's been everybody. It's been, as you mentioned, Paul George. It's been Victor Oladipo. It has been, you know, the Simons not spending enough money. It's been the head coach. It's been Nate McMillan. But, I mean, this is squarely in the lap of Kevin Pritchard. I don't know where else to go with this because he is the one that was committing at first to McMillan and then doubled back on that commitment because of the players. And the players wanted to go this direction. And to me, Bobby, you look at the players and I don't know why anybody other than losing and, you know, somebody not getting the ball enough, you know, these guys that people will point the finger at to doing, maybe possibly doing the complaining, shouldn't be, because I mean, they got what they wanted out of this to this point.
Well, yeah, I mean, when they made the change in the offseason, you know, they wanted a guy that, you know, can kind of, from a player development standpoint and you know, try to take them to that, you know, next level as far as, you know, from a relationship standpoint, building relationships. And I just, I'm almost willing to wave the white flag on a lot of these jobs this year because we're under certainly different situations than we were in the past, and where with COVID and lineup changes and rotations here, and this is not about you know, in a job performance on the court, because I think he's done a pretty good job. But you know, if you didn't do enough background on, as far as to know who you were hiring, like, that falls at your own feet here.
Yeah, and you're right as far as, you know, realizing you make a mistake. I don't know what you got out of what you read from Adrian Wojnarowski's story, but it is far from solidifying that Bjorkgren's going to be back next year. It seems like a warning shot that is not before anything else, Bobby.
Yeah, and we'll see what happens in the next, you know, what do we got, 2 weeks, you know, 10 days here. They'll be one of the playing teams here. We'll see what happens here, but yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it, and what you read is that, you know, can a person change? Can a person kind of change their stripes to, you know, I don't. I mean, we're, you know, 60 games in here, and like all of a sudden you're going to start building relationships with your players differently. Like, you know, like that's hard to do. You know, or building a trust. You know, once players in your locker room don't trust you or don't respect you, and, you know, I don't know enough about the situation, and, you know, besides what I read last night, and having gone through it in New Jersey multiple times, you know, with Avery Johnson and Byron Scott, like, you got no chance. Like, you got no chance of players changing their minds how they think about you.
Seems like, too, when you've been for the players and then they get – what they want, and clearly the players, Bobby, had talked about early on how much they like the switch and how much they like Bjorkgren, and then things go haywire. You have injuries. I mean, you're getting blown out. You give up, you know, 150 plus the other night to the Wizards, which I'm sure should be embarrassing to them, no doubt about that. And, you know, maybe you have a change of heart overall, I guess, if you're the players. But I mean, I think about it this way, I guess. I mean, Brogdon has been deemed, you know, the team leader. And he's the one that was at the forefront, reportedly, that wanted this change. So why should he be complaining if it's coming from the players? Why should Sabonis complain? Because the ball goes through him every time he's on the floor. He's putting up incredible numbers. Miles Turner, injured right now, having the best defensive season of his career so far. Really liked how he was being utilized. So who else on that team, who else in that locker room would be complaining? Why would anybody be complaining other than looking in the mirror and going, I know we're injured, but why are we giving up 150 plus to the Wizards here?
Yeah, I mean, we're not good enough. You know, I mean, I know you've been out with TJ's been out the whole year and or most of the year, and your front court's been really decimated, and you get Sabonis back and you get Karras in the trade to integrate him. But you know, there's clear separation as far as where you are and kind of where that, you know, the top six or top five in the Eastern Conference is. And, you know, we'll see how this, this plays out, but what came out last night was certainly disturbing as far as what the future is going to be here.
It's Bobby Marks, ESPN Front Office Insider. He's on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Before I let you go, Is there ever any going back from anointing the players a great deal of a coaching hiring decision, as clearly what took place in the offseason last year? Is there any going back from that? At that point in time, will they just kind of take advantage of you a little bit? Because it seems like you're put in, if you let the players have a voice, and that's great, but if they have a huge voice in this, it seems like it's going to be hard to double back from.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you've got a roster that's got, you know, James Harden and Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving, and it's a star-studded roster, and, you know, that coach doesn't fit that, then I think you listen to the players. But when you have a roster like Indiana where, you know, outside of Sabonis, there's no all-stars on this group. They're all under contract for next year. There's no leverage here. Right. There's not that one big guy who's going to be a free agent this offseason on an expiring contract who says, hey, you know, I'll come back. But if this guy's not going to be here, I mean, that's not the case here. I mean, if Kevin Durant comes out and tells Sean Marks that he doesn't want Steve Nash anymore, Steve Nash isn't going to be there, you know, like so. But in this situation, that shouldn't be the case, because I don't see any of these guys, this roster, holding that much, stature.
Completely agree. Thank you very much for helping us sift through the drama. And we went through the Vic thing last year. We talked to you about that. And obviously the Paul George stuff was prior to you being at ESPN. But frankly, I'm tired of it. And I know a lot of towns, a lot of markets, a lot of larger cities, you know, media-wise, like dealing with it. But I'm kind of over it by now. There's been much more drama than there has been a consistent level of success to me around here. And that's unfortunate.
Yeah, I mean, it turns you off. I mean, it does. I mean, I get the transaction game, trades, but having lived through, I mean, I don't even know how many coaching changes you go through here. It's like eventually the responsibility lays at the people who do all the hiring. I mean, that's the truth of it.
Yeah. No, you're right. You're absolutely right. I don't know how much you caught of the Pacers, and you know, certainly since they haven't been healthy, it's been tougher, and this has been brought up to me, and you know, TJ Warren's been out the entire year, and now they have a myriad of guys out, but it's been brought up, well, we haven't seen, you know, the product that Kevin Pritchard put together on the floor. My thought has been, even without TJ Warren, I think we've seen enough. What would your thought be in this if you've seen this team play at the very least close, or as close to his full strength as they can be without TJ Warren earlier this year?
Yeah, I mean, I still think they're a 500 team. I mean, I think that's kind of where they are. I mean, they're not where the big boys are up top with three. I mean, there's so many teams that are in that 4-9 range, 4-8 range. You know, there are times when this roster looks really good. You know, I think I'd love to see a full training camp. I'd love to see a healthy roster and with Karis kind of, you know, with a full season of him to see what this team looks like. But it's unfortunately that, you know, we're going to have to wait until, you know, this next October or November to see that.
To me, it doesn't look like that Brogdon's a one that you would want to be a one. Would you agree?
I agree. Yeah. I mean, I think that's kind of, I love when you get TJ in there, you know, McConnell, you know, I mean, but the, I mean, that's going to be the other big thing. And that's probably a conversation down the road. What's going to be the cost of your free agents? You know, McDermott's had a good year. TJ's had a good year. McConnell, you know, like, you know, to bring those guys back, you might be looking, staring right at that luxury tax.
Bobby Marks, always really good with us. I appreciate you more than you know. Every time you reach out, we reach out to you, you jump on here, and I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Thanks. Have a good day.
You too. Bobby Marks of ESPN via the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Listen, I don't know where else to point the finger. You guys have anything in mind? I mean, for the overall, anybody have anything in mind? I mean, obviously, you let the players control this, have a large voice in it. And I know that's the thing you do nowadays, but, I mean, Bobby Marks had a point. Yeah, in the world of Durant and Harden and LeBron, guys like that get that leverage. Guys around here with what they have done, you allow them that type of leverage. That type of voice. To me, and it's not overblown, to me, this is just an incredibly bad look for this team and this organization. I mean, it's one thing to have injuries and to look bad and be circling the drain anyway. But it's another to have described, as we saw last night, the dysfunction that is going on. And where else do you put that? Where else do you place that? I'd like to hear from Kevin at some point and see what the hell is going down. Hey, JMV, in all seriousness, one of the only reasons I've kept my DirecTV is so I can watch the Pacers, and it's at the point now where it's not even worth it. I'm telling you, the apathy is easily set in when it comes to the NBA. A lot of people just aren't built like me. I love basketball. I certainly love NBA basketball. But I know a lot of you, even that can tune in, are going to pay a lot of it. Let me take a break, and we'll return your calls on the other side. Will Fries out of Penn State is going to join us coming up at 4:05. He was a draft selection last week by the Colts. And Kevin Bowen in the 5 o'clock hour on 93.5, 107.5, and 1070 The Fan.
Kids, tell your parents about Forum Credit Union's Sprout of the Month contest, where you could win $100 in a Sprout account. Details at 1075thefan.com.
What's up, everybody? Kevin Bowen here. And if you guys haven't downloaded PropSwap, you are missing out on the best odds in the country. And honestly, that's the greatest thing about PropSwap. You get odds over there that you cannot find anywhere else. Luke Pergandy, owner of PropSwap, joins us now. And Luke, watching the Kentucky Derby over the weekend, it got me thinking about winner Medina Spirit closing at 12-1, but those odds open at 100-1. And that's the beauty of PropSwap. You guys have tickets available with much, much better odds than you can get the day of the race or the day of any game.
Yeah, so the seller obviously got to cash his 100-1 ticket. Say he posted it at new odds of 20-1. So that means he made five times his money. So we had one ticket. He bought it for $20, sold it for 100. And then the PropSwap buyer who paid 100, he got odds of 20-1. When, of course, Medina Spirit was 12-1. So seller makes five times his money and buyer gets the best price in the country.
Again, these are the best odds in the country. And right now, with about a week to go in the NBA season, you guys got a lot of NBA different props available, whether it's team-wise to win their respective conference of the NBA title or even some MVP rookie of the year stuff. And I feel like those Phoenix Suns odds and those Philadelphia 76ers odds are pretty, pretty enticing right now.
Yeah, so the Phoenix Suns were 100-1. To win the NBA Finals, and they are now down to 15-1. Ooh. So if you got a 100-1 ticket, make sure you get that posted right now before the playoffs begin. I think they can make a run. I'm not sure they go to the NBA Finals in a loaded West, but now is the time. If you have a 100-1 ticket, sell it for six times what you paid for it.
Exactly. It's the beauty of PropSwap. You can sell at any point. So download the free PropSwap app today. Go to PropSwap.com as well. The number one app to buy and sell sports bets.
It's time for the Crestpoint Real Estate Market Minute.
I'm Terry Stacey, and joining us is Patrick Keller, managing broker and owner of Crestpoint Real Estate right here in central Indiana. And Patrick, there is some talk out there about some changes with the capital gains tax. What's going on?
Yes, this message is for all investors out there, or people who own second or third homes. Right now in our federal government, there is a proposal to double our capital gains tax. Currently, if an investor or a second home owner would sell their home, they would cap at 20% of their profits would go to Uncle Sam in the form of taxes. Right now, there is a proposal to double that to take it up to nearly 45%, which is significant. So if someone would like an evaluation to try and get in front of those potential tax hikes, we'd love to chat with them about selling.
He's truly one of the best. His name is Patrick Keller, and this has been the Crestpoint Real Estate Market Minute. Indy's real estate experts. Get your home value estimate in 60 seconds at sellwithpatrick.com.
Hey, it's JMV here for Love Heating and Air. Get yourself ready. Your HVAC for the cool in your home in the heat of the summer. Make sure everything's working the way that it should. With John and Chris Love at 317-353-2141. Also, if you feel like you need a new system until the end of May, you can get $600 off the purchase of a high-efficiency air conditioning system from Love Heating and Air. Just mention my name. Get that $600 off. Also, ask about the iWave, state-of-the-art air purification system in your home. Get $125 off by mentioning my name. Hey, mention my name everywhere. There may be some places where they're going to charge you more, but with my good friends at Love Heating and Air, they're going to take a lot off. Deep discounts with my name, with Love Heating and Air. 317-353-2141 online, love-hvac.com today.
A reading from the Golden Oak Lending Book of Mortgage Lingo.
What is a cash-out refi? It's using the equity in your home to pay off high-interest credit cards.
Paid it off! Yes!
I'm James Hawkins, president of Golden Oak Lending. With mortgage rates at a low 2.25%, you can save hundreds each month and skip your next two payments. You'll pay nothing out of pocket, and we never charge for a home appraisal if we can't close your loan. And remember, our local lending experts speak mortgage and love translating for our customers. Eliminating debt means putting your dreams back on the table today.
Updated bathroom?
Updated bathroom and a pool table?
Don't push it, Rick.
Get started with our fast and easy zipline tool at goldenoaklending.com.
NMLS 114937, 2.25% fixed, 3.195% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
The regular season is coming to a close and only a few games left to cheer on your Indiana Pacers live inside Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
They give it to Sabonis.
Score and a foul! DeMontis Sabonis!
Single game Pacer tickets are on sale and a safe fan experience is our top priority.
Brogdon for three.
Got it! Malcolm Brogdon!
The Pacers look to stop Trae Young and the high-flying Atlanta Hawks. Get your tickets at Pacers.com.
Boom, baby!
Pacers Hawks, Thursday at 8.
Hey, Indy. Tim Pearson here, founder of Chattanooga Whiskey, the only Tennessee high malt. Try Chattanooga Whiskey 91, our own rich malt-forward bourbon with four grains, three specialty malts, and finished in a charred white oak Solera barrel. Drink Chattanooga Whiskey and enjoy responsibly.
Big O Tires knows tire and auto repair can be an unexpected expense. That's why they have financing options available, so you pay nothing today. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Hey, join me tomorrow. Mike Strawn is going to join us, the kid out of Charleston who the Colts drafted. Also, Jason Benetti's going to be on board. Join me. It's going to be a great Thursday.
The Ride with JMV.
If somebody gets in your face and calls you a, I want you to be nice.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Bobby Marks, ESPN Front Office Insider, earlier podcast 107.5thefan.com. Slava says, JMV, you should be happy. Fisher is visiting the Colts today. I want Leno, though. I think they should sign Leno. I don't know why you're going to sign a damaged dude, but whatever. Decided to say, make a whole team of damaged dudes. Just do it. Yeah, I know that window's just now cracking open. I am a bit pissy and snarky because I don't dig this Pacer drama. I don't like it, and I'm tired of it. Hey, JMV, they should hire that Naismith guy you're talking about. You made him sound really smart. Yeah, he died in 1939, I think. JMV, one word to describe my feelings on the Pacers right now, disenchanted. Of course, somebody with a little tiny brain like mine, Raphael, would have to look that up. JMV, I know you disagree, but as things are going, I don't think Nate McMillan was that bad. Compare the Pacers and the Hawks. Here's the thing about Nate McMillan. He'd already been fired this year. There's no way. He'd already been fired. Things would not have worked out as nicely for him here this year as it. Can you imagine? I mean, they didn't like him. They supposedly liked Bjorkgren. Supposedly. And I don't know what any of these players, they got what they wanted. So just be quiet. I mean, listen, the team stinks. They're injured. And see, everybody, I think, for the most part, would have complained a little bit, but it went, they're injured, whatever. And now this is just a dark cloud that's over everything. Dysfunction. It just makes you look like a clown show. Oh, yeah. I want, speaking of the Colts, I wanted Charles Leno. But apparently you've had to have played for either the Chiefs or the Eagles to get a chance as a free agent with the Colts. Hey, Jamby, did I miss something about Malcolm Brogdon being the best thing since sliced bread? I don't know what he would be complaining about either. Just for the sake of complaining, he got exactly what he wanted. He was leading the charge of what he wanted, and now he gets to run around and shoot and dribble a lot and not play any defense. That's like a basketball player's dream. And get paid $20 million to do it. Where do I sign up? All right. Kevin Bowen, 5 o'clock hour. Will Fries of Penn State is going to join us coming up at 4:05. We had a Sean Davis reschedule a little bit earlier. Luke Bryan tickets, too. I'm going to get to your calls. I got a lot on tap for you, an hour or two. You guys sit tight. Back with you next.
A reading from the Golden Oak Lending Book of Mortgage Lingo.
What is a no-charge appraisal? It's never asking for a credit card or charging for a home appraisal if we can't close your loan.
No risk on refinancing, but I live for danger.
I'm James Hawkins, president of Golden Oak Lending. Refinancing with Golden Oak is anything but risky business. And with our mortgage rates at a low 2.25%, you can save hundreds each month and skip your next two payments. And remember, our local lending experts speak mortgage and love translating for our customers. Removing risk from your next purchase or refi means you can find your thrills elsewhere.
Skydiving? No, cliff jumping. Wait, hang gliding.
Aren't you afraid of heights?
Stop, you're embarrassing me.
Get started today with our simple zipline tool at goldenoaklending.com.
Hey, NMLS 1149.37, 2.25% fixed, 3.195% APR, FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
I swear to God that was over. My bad. Hey, John here, and if you're in the market for a new ride, here you go. Eric Wilson, my friends at Andy Moore Buick GMC and Fisher's 131st and State Road 37. Tell them I sent you today on the great deals they have, I mean, across the lot. I know a lot of you are thinking about getting a new set of wheels. Month of May, feeling good, right? Yeah, let's get a new ride. And they have the best deals for you anywhere. And I know you've also driven up 37 and you go, hey, there's some construction here. Don't mind it. It's not a problem because you're going to get the best deals anywhere. One-stop shopping with my friend Eric Wilson and Andy Moore Buick GMC. Tell him I sent you. 131st and State Road 37 in Fishers today.
From the first pitch to the last out, Bet Rivers Sportsbook has all the bases covered. Bet Rivers has a massive number of baseball betting options on each game, including pre-game player props and live in-game betting every inning. Sign up now and get a free play match of 100% on your first deposit up to $250. Bet with a winner. Bet with Bet Rivers Sportsbook. Must be 21 or over to play. Playable only in Indiana. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Circle K is America's thirst stop. And yours. Especially when the weather gets... and you need to stay... stay refreshed on the go with ice-cold Circle K favorites like freshly ground iced coffee, Froster, Polar Pop Cup, and more. And right now at Circle K, save on all 20-ounce Pepsi products. 3 for $4.25. When life's go, make us your first stop. Because Circle K is America's thirst stop.
Hello, this is Jeff Bassett with Bassett Services. It's time to change that air filter and to schedule your tune-up. Visit us at BassettServices.com.
Bassett Services is your trusted local independent American Standard air dealer.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2, W29ABB, WIBC, HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
Phillies, Braves, Sunday Night Baseball. The coverage begins at 6 on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
Don't read your email, because I'm really butthurt when you read your email.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
That's what I sound like today, right there. What I sound like. Yeah, I saw this last night. I just go, you got to be kidding me. Thank you for joining us, Bobby Marks of ESPN, a little bit earlier. They're ESPN front office insider. joined us. All right, here's the reason why. By the way, Will Fries, Penn State, is going to join us in a couple of minutes here, so hang on for that. Here's the reason why I came out. What did I just say in that reentry? Butthurt or pissy or whatever. They all apply because I am. I seriously am. Now, that doesn't mean I'm not enjoying the sunshine of the day. I got to mow and all that crap today, right? But, yeah, this has made me pissy. Amid a year of difficulties with players and staff, Pacers coach Nate Bjorkman's future with the franchise is uncertain as the regular season nears an end. Bjorkman has work to do on relationships with key players in his locker room. Thus far has shown a willingness within the organization to try to address those issues. Well, I guess you would, because otherwise you're going to get canned, which you may end up getting canned anyway. And listen, he hasn't been great by any stretch of the imagination, but I just want to know, who are these players? Who are these key players that aren't getting what they want because they got what they want? Here's what I don't want. I don't want to watch him give up 150-plus. Andy Moore, Automotive Group Hotline right now. I'm going to jump back to all that in a second and get to your calls. But he heard his name called last weekend, and I saw that celebration that he had, and it looked awesome. Will Fries, he's an offensive lineman out of Penn State, with us now. Hello, Will. How are you?
Good. How are you doing? Thanks for having me.
I thought that was a special moment with you, family, and friends. How awesome was that?
Oh, it was so amazing. I mean, just getting that call and all the emotion that goes into it, and being there with my family and friends, and supporting me through that day, and having them around, just so incredible, something I'll never forget.
Did you hang tight throughout the draft, waiting on that moment?
Oh yeah, I mean, I was sitting around all day, keeping track of everything, who was going where. My buddies brought a football over, playing catch, throughout the thing, trying to take my mind off of it. But it was a good time.
I can't imagine. Is there anything that do you even think of, or stop thinking about it, I guess, in this case, for even a minute?
Yeah, I mean, when I went outside, I was just trying to enjoy the time with my friends. I mean, it was stressful. You just never know what's going to happen, especially on day three, something like that. But like I said, it was cool to have them and, just take my mind off of it for a little bit.
What'd you think coming out of Penn State your opportunities might have been here? Did you expect to get your name called?
Yeah, I was, very, lucky and fortunate to have my name ultimately called by the Colts. Didn't know what was going to happen, talking with, my agent and, a bunch of interviews throughout the process, thought there was a good chance. And, I'm just happy it worked out. I think I'm in a great location, a great spot, and I have a great opportunity here with Indianapolis.
What'd you think about, and again, Will Fries joins us, former offensive lineman of Penn State on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Thinking back of a lot of things that went on while you were at Penn State, what'd you think about your career there?
Yeah, I was, fortunate to have a great career there. Was able to, play 4 years there, have a bunch of starts, play a bunch of different positions, and I think that's ultimately what helped me throughout the process is, being flexible, playing, both guard and tackle, and, learning to snap the football too. I'm just going to try and, contribute any way I can, now that I'm in Indy.
Was that a part of, I don't know how much you've talked to Chris or, Chris Strasser, for example, or anybody, was that a part of the draw you think the Colts had to you, was that versatility you had between tackle and guard?
Yeah, I think so for sure. I think that, starting most of my career tackle and then, kicking over to guard this season, being able to play at a high level both positions, I think that was, ultimately a factor in, being part of the Colts now.
Hey, there are worse things in the world than being known as the jack of all trades. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, there's no doubt. I mean, it's a good situation to be in.
It is. And especially you look at this offensive line and, from Quentin Nelson to Ryan Kelly to Mark Glowinski to Braden Smith. I mean, there are some dudes on this offensive line I'm sure you know a little bit about.
Oh, for sure. Just being in college and, trying to, get better, you're starting to watch those guys, watch, different players throughout the league. And, definitely watched a lot of these guys, while I was in college. And, guys I definitely look up to and look forward to learning a ton from.
All right, when did you make the transition? Were you always, obviously weren't as always big as you are now, but were you always a lineman growing up in football?
I was always a lineman. you know, I actually had my first start this year was at blocking tight end, so, you know, I can play there as well.
Uh-oh. See, you got to let everybody know that because that you're in the game. That could get you in the end zone, man.
That's what I'm saying. You know, that'd be great to, you know, get a touchdown.
Wait, I haven't seen the hands. How are the hands?
You know, tight end, you know, ultimately wasn't my position, you know, coming out of college. But, you know, I'm not saying there's not a future there as well. You know, anything to help the team, right?
Well, you're not catching – you're not using oven mitts to catch or anything, right? You're all good. You got that thing.
Yeah, I got it.
Will Fries joins us. He's drafted by the Colts and heard his name called. He's on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Some things maybe people around here don't know about. I mean, obviously with your Big Ten background, and I'm going to get to that in just a second, they know you regarding that, but some things they don't know about you growing up, football, other sports, things you like to do, things that people may be unaware of about you here.
Yeah, so, you know, from Cranford, New Jersey, you know, grew up playing, you know, football, basketball, you know, baseball through the shot put and discus in high school. Really liked doing that. You know, I think that's one of those things that helps you, you know, with football, ultimately, you know, those explosiveness and all that stuff. So that was great. You know, outside of Will, a football player, love to fish. You know, that's probably my biggest hobby. You know, I'll do anything, you know, pond fishing, you know, stream fishing, you know, ocean fishing out in New Jersey. Love all that stuff. Love the barbecue too. You know, got a little smoke in my backyard. I was making ribs.
Nice.
Saturday.
That goes over well, man. That's now what type of smoker do you use?
It's a little vertical smoker. I forget the name of it. It's, you know, it's old one from my dad's friends or something. But you can cook anything you want on there. Ribs, pulled pork, you know, brisket, whatever you want.
Let me tell you this. When you get here, I'm going to hook you up with a couple of people when you get here. Pat Sullivan of Sullivan Hardware and Garden, and then Mark Sion, who has he is a sales dude for the Big Green Egg. Have you ever heard of the Big Green Egg?
I have heard of the Big Green Egg. That's a outstanding smoker.
It is. Well, we'll hook you up because I know Mark and Pat both listen to this show religiously, and we'll hook you up because that is at the top of if you want to be a great smoker of meat, that is what you have to have. Now, I don't know where you're going to be living or what's going to be happening, but we got to get you hooked up with the Big Green Egg.
Perfect. I'll have all you guys over, and I'll cook up some meat for you guys.
Is the ribs, is that your forte?
I think that's the best thing I've done so far.
I hose everything I put. I don't know if you've tried brisket, but I'm a mess on brisket. Just can't do it.
Brisket's tough. You know, I haven't really dabbled too much into brisket yet, but, you know, that's, you know, considered the king.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. Will Fries joins us out of Penn State. Have you heard anything, been told anything about once you get here? And I know you're going to have rookie camp to get acclimated and such. What's your expectation when you get here?
You know, not sure, you know, you know, where they want to start me off at, but I'm, you know, willing to do everything I can, you know, play all over the line, you know, learn all the different positions, but really just want to, you know, like you said, get acclimated, you know, start learning the playbook, so, you know, just keep getting ready to roll and, you know, just be a part of this team and keep learning.
All right, Will, I got to ask you one final question. I mean, you know, we're in Indy, and there are a lot of IU fans listening right now. Did Michael Penix get that ball into the end zone?
I don't think he did. I know I'm going to get crushed for this by the Indiana fans, but you know, the way that game was going, I don't think the ref was going to overturn it, you know, being so close.
How much of a conversation did you guys have on the way home about that? I mean, because that was one of the bigger plays of the season, really, anywhere that he made.
Yeah, I mean, I guess credit to him, you know, played his heart out, you know, great player. You know, made a play for his team when he needed it. So, you know, credit to Michael Penix.
Yeah, it's just I had to ask. And I'm sure you probably went over that a couple of different times. Hey, before I let you go, I've talked to a lot of different college players on how difficult it was to get through that what was happening a season ago. How difficult was it for you? Because you finally got to play, and that's great. Things don't go your way. But you still have to follow incredible protocols and have to be really focused about making sure you're going to be, you know, eligible to play, things of that. How difficult was that all together to get this thing off the ground in the first place?
Yeah, you know, for me, it really wasn't that difficult because kind of like you said, when the season was canceled, everyone's crushed. But once you have that opportunity, you know, I mean, I just look at it as we got to go. Like, there's nothing to complain about now. I mean, yeah, this isn't fun, like the protocol is getting tested every day, but I mean, we're lucky enough to go out there and play every single day and, you know, do what we wanted to do. And I just remember that feeling every day, how crushed we were when they told us they were canceling. So, you know, I just gave my heart to it every day and, you know, did everything I could for the team.
All right, Will, in closing here, I don't know if you got Christian with you or Matt Conte or whomever, but I'm gonna get you with the Big Green Egg guys and Mark Sion. He's over there in Brownsburg near your facility. And then I got Calvin Fitch, who heard you suggest that you're a big-time fisherman. Calvin Fitch is a listener to the show, and he's a Bassmaster. So are you at that level of fishing Bassmaster, or are you just kind of hanging out and what the hell?
You know, I wouldn't consider myself a Bassmaster, but I would consider myself, you know, maybe an intermediate working up to be a Bassmaster. So, you know, I'd love to, you know, go out fishing with them and learn some tricks of the trade.
I like it. And you got Eagle Creek right over there near the facility, too. So we'll get you hooked up with – see, I mean, that's what happens. Come on the show anytime, and if you have any needs, we'll make sure those needs are met. Okay?
That's perfect.
Well, I appreciate it.
I'll be on a lot.
Congratulations on being a part of this. And, you know, I watched that video, and it was awesome to see the way that you and your family and friends embraced that moment. And the best of luck to you.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me on.
You got it. Will Fries right there of Penn State via the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Yeah, just go ahead and call, and I'll just whatever need you might have. You know, we should start doing that, too. And I know Mark Sion's listening right now, and I know Pat Sullivan's listening right now. They can get it done. That's outstanding. Hey, my advice is to check it out, too. Just Google his name. You can see that celebration video. It's pretty cool. Yeah, I know. I had to ask the Penix question. There's no doubt. No doubt. And it's unsurprising that he didn't think so. Oh, yeah. Matthew Stansbury says, so by you guys, does that mean the lounge? Yeah, you guys in the lounge have any needs? What do you guys got? Any needs whatsoever? Yeah, my one major need right now for this show is my need to stop having this Pacer team with stupid drama and a soap opera. And for those of you that are saying, oh, you're making too much out of this, crap. Crap. It is a bad look. And, well, you know, you have to ask who did it, what the motivation might be, but it is crap. So, yeah, inside the lounge, just let me know. I'm telling you what, I screw up some brisket now. And Calvin Fitch, you got to get together with my man here. Seven says, I need a new deck. See, I love it. Now you guys are giving me your needs at JMV 1070. Sevens needs a new deck. Anybody out there build Sevens a new deck? Reggie Sykes says your number one could use a big green egg. Scott Kenworthy says, smoking meat, catching bass. Your Green County roots are showing through. I know we should hang out. I've never been a big fishing guy. I'd probably go. Like, I'll give you a great example. I drive home, and I've said this before, right? I drive home down Bluff, and I go underneath the bridge, the Raymond Bridge there at White River, and I see all these people down there fishing, and I'm thinking, man, I mean, it has to be just for the fun of it because there's no way you're eating anything out of that thing, right? I mean, you're not going to catch a fish and eat that thing, are you? Just kind of wonder. And river fishing doesn't look fun. I will say this. I've never been, and he mentioned, you know, ocean fishing, you know, off the coast of New Jersey. I have never been. I'd love to go to the Gulf of Mexico. I think that'd be fun. Madison Foster says, if you have a beer sponsor, your boy here wouldn't mind a handout. Oh, Madison Foster, tomorrow, District Tap downtown. I've got Hawks Pacers tickets for you. And we got to get our folks from, as they say, down in southern Indiana, Coors Light. And yeah, I'm allowed to say that because that's where I'm from. Coors Light. You know, and that's that part of southern Indiana where they still call John Mellencamp Johnny Cougar. Yeah, Johnny Cougar. Yeah, you know, I really loved that American Fool. Johnny Cougar's really good. Johnny Cougar. Johnny Cougar and Coors Light. That's where I'm from. Johnny Cougar. Yeah, well, Johnny Cougar and American Fool. Anyway, I'll try to help out everybody. See, I should have mentioned that, too. I know Braden Smith is a fisherman. Ryan Kelly is, too. Because remember, Ryan Kelly was on this show, and the first thing he was going to buy was a bass boat.
Well, that was right before the Pro Bowl.
Yeah,
and he
the
said
Pro Bowl.
If
yes.
they won, yeah. then, you know, the winner of the Pro Bowl gets a little more money. He was right. going to use that money for a bass boat.
Yeah. True story right there. See, I wish that would have struck me 10 minutes ago instead of now. Yeah, I know. Chuck DeBlue. And that's his name. Chuck DeBlue has been all over me for my cult stuff. And apparently Chuck wants me to go more in depth and to talk to the practice squad quarterback and such. I think we do a pretty damn good job, if I do say so myself, on this. So I don't know if I need to be taking Chuck DeBlue's advice. But Chuck DeBlue was on me last night about, and it was weird, it was about my take on Terrence Marshall Jr. in the second round. Oh, that's all you ever talk about. Well, you know, I've only had 2 days to talk about it, and I only bring it up when it matters. I mean, I haven't railed on it by any stretch of the imagination. And I think sometimes what, like, people like Chuck DeBlue forget is, I've got an ever-changing audience. Like, I'm going to go ahead and rehash the Wojnarowski tweets in a minute because some are going to be joining right now and may not really know the context in which I've been ripping on the Pacers. Shout out to Chuck DeBlue, friend of the show. Did you see that last night? I couldn't even... Like, I was so busy missing shots last night, I couldn't even concentrate on Chuck DeBlue. Yeah, tarpon fishing. Shout out, Eric Terrell. In the Gulf. Yeah, and I grew up with Johnny Cougar. They still say Johnny Cougar. Hey, JMV, I've been picking up on a growing distrust for Bjorkgren from Sabonis and Brogdon late in some games. I don't disagree with that, Yaney. Here's the problem I have with that. They're both catered to, and that is BS. Both. Sabonis with some incredibly inflated numbers. He should love that. Brogdon, because he dribbles and shoots and plays no defense. He should love that. I would love that. You would love that. It typically comes when inevitably Nate forgets to put his starters back in until it's too late in the fourth quarter. His mismanagement of players' minutes and trying to leave certain groups in too long has been a frustrating problem for the top-tier players. I'm not surprised by the report, but I agree it doesn't help anything with the timing. Now, it makes it look like a clown show, Yaney, is what it does. Here's the other problem I have with the players. This is exactly what they wanted. For those of you saying they'd be better off with McMillan right now, they would have had Nate fired long ago. Well, they did. But let's just say, for example, he went into this season. There's no way that dude would still be here. None. Hey, JMV, what's the deal with Brogdon? Is he really hurting the team off the court? Have heard a lot of rumors. Josh Whitson. I mean, you do hear rumors, and obviously he's supposed to be the spokesperson of the team. Obviously he was at the front of the group that did not want McMillan as the head coach and wanted the new era brought in and embraced Bjorkgren. And if he has a problem with Bjorkgren right now, I think we all should have a problem with him because he's the one that wanted it. No doubt. All right. Let me take a quick call. Bill is talking Pacers at 239-1070. Hello, Bill.
Hey, JMV, how you doing
afternoon? What's up, buddy?
I want to talk a little Pacers, but if anybody that wants to do some serious fishing and can drive about 6 hours west coast of Michigan, like around Traverse City or...
I hate Michigan. I think Michigan sucks. I can't go
there. Well, you know, it does, but, man, that, if you're a fisherman, that you can get a charter there, and it's good fishing, and it's not the White River, but...
I think I'd rather go under the Raymond Street Bridge and fish than go to Michigan.
Well, you might be able to find some contraband down there as well.
But, I can imagine, yeah.
The thing I'm going to be watching with the Pacers tonight is two different things. Number one, you know, they got to lose that stupid three-man weave program that we all ran in junior high school up at the top of the key that doesn't allow the defense to have to switch or rotate or do anything.
And everybody does that dribble handoff stuff now.
But the Pacers, I don't remember them getting hardly any points off of it at all. And when's the last time you've seen a Pacer run out on defense to try to at least disrupt an outside shooter?
Yeah.
Every time they rotate the ball, the outside shooter, you know, takes a break, gets a cup of coffee and everything, and then shoots the ball.
Just line that thing up. There's no – closeouts are a problem. I mean, just – I'm assuming they're a problem because you're so far off because you know you're going to take a beating off the dribble if you're not. So that's what you see.
One thing or the other, but I think to save the season, we need to start McConnell at the point and let him run the show. Because he's the only one that wants to play the point. Aaron Holiday doesn't. Aaron Holiday wants to shoot outside. And Brogdon does too. And, you know, the thing about player development is you can be good at wanting to have player development, but if the player doesn't want to be developed anything different than what their meal ticket is, they're just not going to do it. So we got to start drafting players that are defensive-minded players or players that can play the point and not going to gravitate over to the outside.
Well, my suggestion would be for Kevin is just to draft players that can play. How about that?
Can they do that?
We start right there.
Yeah. That's a heck of a good start. And just because Brogdon played pretty well and looked good in Milwaukee, I might be able to look pretty good too if I was playing.
Let me tell you this. This is Bill. This is Bill, huge Pacer fan, who's normally incredibly positive. But it sounds like this is your last straw too.
No, I'm not, until the Titanic totally goes under and everything, I'm going to look for a life raft. But I think that life raft is going to be McConnell.
All right. Hey, I appreciate you, Billy. We'll look for you coming up tomorrow down at the District Tap of Coors Light. Reds win today in 10 over the White Sox, 1-0. But this is life as a Reds fan. So you're happy that they win 1-0 in 10, but then you just wait for that nut kick. And that nut kick in the form of Joey Votto, fractured thumb. It's going to be weeks for sure, according to David Bell. Joey Votto, fractured thumb. Reds fans, Cincinnati fans can't have anything good. That's why when everybody was complaining about, you know, taking Chase instead of Sewell, it's not going to matter because crap's going to happen anyway. I mean, Cincinnati fans are not allowed anything nice. They just won't. Yeah, something good happens, and then two bad things happen. So, Votto with a fractured thumb. When's the last time the Reds shut out a team? Can we look that up? Does anybody know? And I know you guys don't care about it right now, so I'm not going to stick with it. It was just a thought because it was an afternoon game. Inside the Lounge on YouTube Live is where everybody right now is talking about stuff. And we're going over the Pacer crapola. I'll revisit Adrian Wojnarowski's tweet and then story about what apparently is dysfunction within the Pacers and where this stupid, ridiculous, embarrassing story may have come from. Bobby Marks helped explain it a little bit earlier. ESPN, ESPN.com, front office insider. His podcast is up, 1075thefan.com. Will Fries, Colts draft selection, 7th round, 248 overall. Talked about that moment when his name was called and coming to Indy and more. That's also going to be up on a podcast, 1075thefan.com. All right, let me take a break. We'll come back. I'll line up some calls. I'll get to your comments via YouTube Live in the lounge and remind you that tonight the Pacers are in action. So if this whole baloney was meant to fire up a team against Sacramento, then well done. See, John Matthews says, Votto out, good. Moose to first, Suarez to third. Who's playing shortstop? Me? Kyle Farmer? Remember, the Reds didn't go after a shortstop. That's why Suarez has been in shortstop. Who's playing shortstop? Kyle Farmer, I guess. Or me. Did you look up when's the last time the Reds shut out a team? Oh, wait a minute. April 12th,
yeah,
according to David.
It was recent. Well, yeah, versus the Giants.
I tell you, my short term's getting worse, David. Getting worse. 3-0. They shut out the Giants on the 12th. Wow. I must have forgotten about that. All right, quick break and we'll return. Latest conversation regarding the Pacers. We'll get back to that. And Kevin Bowen, 5 o'clock hour. Your calls on the other side, 93.5, 107.5, and 1070, the Fan.
Mortgage interest rates have started to rise. At the Home Loan Expert office, we are still locking loans in the twos. How much can you save? TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
We know the month of May is all about racing in our great state, but before we get there, you've got some money to make over on PropSwap. I'm Kevin Bowen, and I can't tell you how much I've loved scouring PropSwap over the past few months. PropSwap is the eBay of sports betting, with props available to buy or sell that have the best odds in the country. Right now, there are gobs of NBA playoff, end-of-season award props available, and even some for the PGA Championship coming up, which, of course, I love. I've also got some great news for you looking to add to your PropSwap account. For any user, not just a new user, any user, you can earn a free deposit bonus up to $100 with the promo code FREE100. Again, that's a free deposit bonus up to $100 with the promo code FREE100. If you're not buying and selling on PropSwap, you are missing out. On average, sellers are making $500 a month. So download the PropSwap app or head to PropSwap.com today.
Hey, John here for L.D. Smith Plumbing. Shout out to Lance and his local team, making sure if you have any plumbing issues whatsoever, they've got all the answers for you, 317-284-9526. And no matter the size of the job, if it's hard, if it's easy, if it's an emergency, it is 24/7, 365 services for you. All right, have you been thinking about this? Are you ready? A new hot water heater. Let's go tankless. Let's go tankless right now and mention my name and save $300 on a tankless water heater that's going to save you money and energy costs and give you endless gallons of hot water. It is awesome. $300 off right now just by mentioning my name. Yeah, I saw that too. Something fell off the building. Weird. 317-284-9526, 317-284-9526 in L.D. Smith Plumbing, the absolute best. Tell Lance that I sent you online, ldsmithplumbing.com today.
Rick Edelman, award-winning radio host and founder of Edelman Financial Engines, takes questions on his radio show. Let's hear his answer on long-term care.
Hi, Rick. I'm worried about the cost of long-term care. Should I get insurance?
You're smart to ask, because one in two Americans over 65 will need long-term care. But do you need the insurance? It depends on your financial situation. If you're rich, you don't need insurance because you can afford the costs. If you're poor, Medicaid will pay for your care. But if you're in the middle class, the cost of care could push you and your spouse into poverty. Before you buy insurance, consider your complete finances, including your savings and investments. Get independent advice from someone who will give you the guidance you need and that's in your best interest.
That's Rick Edelman, founder of Edelman Financial Engines. If you're looking for a trusted partner, talk to one of our financial planners by calling 888-PLAN-RICK or visit rickedelman.com.
Hubler has it, savings. Hubler has it, choices.
Hubler really does have it all.
savings, service, selection, and a whole lot more. All of our pre-owned vehicles are Hubler Q certified. Every Q certified vehicle includes a 128-point vehicle inspection, a free Carfax vehicle history report, and not one, but two warranties. A 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and a 30-day, 1,000-mile comprehensive warranty. But that's not all. Each Q certified vehicle on our lot has fewer than 100,000 miles or is less than 9 years old. Looking to sell your car? Hubler will pay top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Come see why Hoosiers have trusted Hubler for 60 years. Visit any of our 13 locations today or click drivehubler.com.
Hubler has it all.
Hey, John, for Kinetico, if you're thinking about a new career path, let Joe, John, and Dennis and Kinetico, a fantastic company, help you out. They are hiring multiple service technicians. So if you're good with tools, with your hands, figuring out problems, and you like really good pay, incredible benefits, how about Kinetico today? And that company, that is great, with Joe, John, and Dennis. Again, several, multiple service technician positions are being hired right now. So take a chance on that if you're looking for that new career path with my friends at Kinetico. For all the info online, KineticoIndy.com today.
When it comes to working at Geico, our best advocates are our employees, like Michael. But since he is so focused on growing his career, we hired an actor to read his story.
If you want a job where you get out as much as you put in, Geico is the best place to work. Plus, we promote from within, so there are no ceilings placed on your opportunities.
They even offer parental leave to full-time employees. So there's nothing stopping him from going all the way to the top. But not too high. He's scared of heights.
Ready to start your career, Indy? We're hiring claim sales and service agents. Apply online today at geico.job/Indy.
After such an extraordinary year, it's time to celebrate the most extraordinary member of the family, Mom. Diamonds Direct invites you to join us as we say cheers to the mothers in our lives. We've put together an exceptional collection of affordable and meaningful gifts for any budget. Birthstone rings, stackable rings, eternity bands, pearls, elegant diamond pendants, and of course, stunning diamond earrings. This year, more than ever, Mom deserves a gift that's anything but ordinary. So let the experts at Diamonds Direct help you find that remarkable gift. Diamonds Direct.
The Ride with JMV.
One, is this or is this not the XFL? Yes, it is. Two, do I or do I not currently have a pulse? Yes, I do. Let's play football.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Hey, welcome back. JMV at 1070, thefan.com is the email address. JMV, I was so glad to hear the caller mention that the weave, dribble, handoff stuff the Pacers run. Drives me crazy. Mostly when Domas is in there, they dribble, they hand it off a bunch, clock runs down, someone has to take a bad shot every time. It seems just like a waste of time. When you have guys like LeVert and Sumner in there just attacking the bucket, the offense looks much better. Mike in Portland, Oregon. Thank you, Mike. Yeah, and see, those of you that know me, you know that I'm not a hot take artist. You know that I'm not pissing and moaning just to do that. And I've told you before, nothing sells this show to listeners more than winning, more than success, more than, hey, everything is great type of conversation. I mean, listen, people will want to talk about stuff when it's going haywire, but you guys get tired of it. So, yeah, don't bring the whole hot take crap to me. Don't. I've got plenty to talk about, but this one just inspired me in conversation last night because I thought it made everybody look bad. And I don't care if you're talking about a rookie head coach. I don't care who you're talking about with the injuries. Not about any of that. Somebody within that organization decided to cut loose something that shouldn't have been. It makes you look like a clown show. It does. There's no hot take in that. That is absolutely the truth. So I don't want to hear it. And if that's what you're saying, then take it someplace else. You guys have known me for long enough. You know I don't do that. Brandon Reef writes this. I don't understand why Pritchard keeps getting a pass every year. At some point, he needs to be held accountable. Well, I mean, this whole thing falls. It falls at his doorstep. There's no doubt about it. I mean, you were just trying to figure out exactly who would decide to unleash this nugget. It just doesn't fall out of the sky for Wojnarowski. You know, who decided to go ahead and drop that out there? You know, was it a player? Was it somebody in the front office? What's the benefit? Seriously, if I'm such a hot take artist, what's the benefit here? Oh, well, that's just everybody's injured. Oh, yeah, great. What world are you living in? Again, if you missed it, too, here was the tweet from last night, the subsequent story written afterwards. Amid a year of difficulties with players and staff, Pacers coach Nate Bjorkgren's future with the franchise is uncertain as the regular season nears an end. Bjorkgren has work to do on relationships with key players in his locker room. All right, so take the path. He's a rookie head coach. Those players wanted him. They wanted this. I mean, you look at players, I mean, even in a bad season, an injury-riddled season, Sabonis is putting up big numbers. Basically, everything goes through him. Turner was mentioned as Defensive Player of the Year before his toe injury. Brogdon, what he says, everybody apparently takes as gospel anyway. And then he dribbles and shoots and doesn't play any defense. What's not to love about that? So who has the problem? Where's the problem here? You all just acting like petulant children? Well, you just realize that the rookie head coach doesn't have what you thought. And with Kevin Pritchard in mind, I've said this the entire time. The team to me doesn't really match. Well, really doesn't really is not even close. It doesn't match how Bjorkgren wants to play. You don't have the right parts. You've got square pegs and round hole features. But believe me, there's nothing hot take about that. Yeah, what's the benefit, too? What's the benefit for the front office? I mean, let's say, for example, I know a lot of people are going to go, oh, it's not coming from Kevin Pritchard or anybody. But let's just say, I mean, we'll go over this entire thing. What if it is? I mean, you're just kind of getting the word out there that they're going to make a change. After 1 year with one guaranteed year remaining, did you make the wrong move? Because initially, you remember, they were going to go with McMillan. And then the players helped change his mind to go a different direction. And that direction became Nate Bjorkgren. And everybody seemed really happy about it. Now they don't. So who's unhappy? Why are you unhappy? Are you more unhappy about this than giving up 150-plus points to the Wizards the other night? Because I'm telling you, before this, and a lot of you may disagree, and that's okay, but before this, I bet most of you would probably look at the injury situation and say, hey, who are they going to beat anyway? Right? I mean, who are you logically going to beat anyway? Before this, and now this takes the stage. And as I suggest, we've had more of this than we have seen success, at least consistent success. Every stinking year, it seems like drama. It seems like a soap opera. Had to go through the Vic stuff last year. I mean, at what point does anybody out there believe maybe Victor Oladipo had a point? You know, because I told you stories about how he did not like Pritchard. And everybody just have, including myself, kind of put that in the category of guy just didn't want to be here, guy wants out. Now, did he have a point? That's all I've ever done is rip Paul George. Paul George have a point? Why the soap opera? Why the drama? I mean, that's worth asking. There's no hot take artistry about that whatsoever. 239-1070. Email address is JMV at 1070thefan.com. I mean, really, everybody's been blamed. Everybody's had the finger pointed at them. Nobody's pointed the finger at Kevin yet. Kevin's driving this thing. But seriously, I mean, everybody's been blamed. Players been blamed. Coach has been blamed. Ownership's been blamed. Got to squash crap like this. And frankly, it's not so much, I'm just sick of it. I'm just sick of it. All right, 239-1070. Email address is JMV at 1070thefan.com. We shall start with Jonah in Arizona. Hello, Jonah.
JMV, how are you?
I am great. Thank you for the call.
I was going to say, the tone of your voice could tell me that you're a little bit irritated today, I can understand.
I'm just tired. I'm just tired of it. I am. I'm tired of it.
No, I understand. Yeah.
Because I care too much, and I do. I love NBA, and you know, I want to see the Pacers play well, and I understand the obstacles this year. But to me, you know, stuff like last night is crap, and, yeah, that does piss me off a little bit, yeah.
I had season tickets to the Pacers for 8 years, from 2004 to 2012, so I hear you. But I don't have a hot take, but I do have an obscure stat for you before I get to the Pacers.
Okay.
So to the 31 people that in Indiana that care about baseball, and to the one person that likes the Braves outside of my brother, the Braves starting pitcher, Waskar Inoa, hit a home run in his last game. And then last night, in his next start, he hit a grand slam. That's the first pitcher in Braves history to do back-to-back home runs for a pitcher. And the shortest span in between games was 9 games when Warren Spahn did it in 1962. Now, if that's not a cool stat, I don't know.
That's a hell of a stat you got there, Jonah. That's why I enjoy you calling the show. Well done.
Thank you. And I'm also trying to get some Indiana people to be Braves fans, but it's kind of
different. I got you.
I know, as a Reds fan, you don't like that. So I'm not really one to knee-jerk about coaches or players that should go after 1 year. And I was giving him a pass at the beginning of the season because of all the injuries. I mean, no matter who the coach is, all these injuries are going to make it difficult. And I liked his game plan at the beginning of the season. He looked like he was the right coach for this. But even now, I'm not entirely sure, even before last night, I'm seeing some of the worst defense I have ever seen in my life.
And I agree with you. I agree with you. I think that people, like you just, you notice that, right? I mean, people that are watching notice that. There's no reason, you know, there's no reason to sound the bullhorn over this, because I think everybody notices how this looks right now with a rookie head coach and how things have gone. So I just think what was released informationally and given to Wojnarowski last night, I think it embarrasses everybody. It makes it look like a clown act.
Well, and here's another thing that really irritates me. I had season tickets, I told you, during 2007 to 2010, during the Pacers' dark years, where they didn't have a lot of talent. So and those are some bad defensive teams then, because they tried. They just couldn't defend well, so what they did is they outscored their opponents to win games. If they would score 110 or more, usually they would win. But I was actually seeing them try to play defense. This year, I'm seeing the Pacers score 124 points and still losing. That is unacceptable. And part of that, a lot of that has to fall on coaching. And I know the players are the ones that play, and I've been seeing just lackluster defense. And I've said it last time, and I'm going to say it again, getting rid of Dan Burke was a huge mistake.
Yeah, and so, thank you. Jonah, thank you for the call. I appreciate that. It's funny, too, when people say, yeah, they should have kept McMillan. There's no, he wouldn't have, he'd already be gassed. You know that. Hey, maybe it is. I mean, maybe this is organizationally. Maybe that is kind of, and we talked about this with Bobby Marks a little bit earlier. I mean, maybe that is kind of setting the stage, making you aware that thought is in mind. You know, I guess everybody out there logically believes it's going to come from a player. Maybe not. Maybe not. But, yeah, to me, this was all noticeable stuff just by watching the game. I mean, it doesn't take a tweet and then a story afterward of dysfunction with a rookie head coach, I think, to get people to watch the Pacers on the reg around here to understand that things aren't good, don't seem good, and maybe aren't built for the long-term future. I mean, hell, we've talked about that for a while. Quick break, and we shall return. If you're on hold, I'll get to you. Top of the hour, Kevin Bowen. Got your chance at Luke Bryan tickets and more. 93.5, 107.5, and 1070, The Fan.
Kids, tell your parents about Forum Credit Union's Sprout of the Month contest, where you could win $100 in a Sprout account. Details at 1075thefan.com.
Today is nonstop. And suddenly, your checking account is overdrawn. But what if we gave you more time on that one? At Huntington, if you accidentally overdraw your account by $50 or less, we've put a $50 safety zone in place, so you won't be charged an overdraft fee. It's one more way we're looking out for you. So you can have time for what matters most. Huntington, welcome. $50 safety zone does not apply to returned items. Your account will be automatically closed if it remains negative for 60 days. Learn more at Huntington.com/safety zone.
Hey, Johnny, for Love Heating and Air. Love Heating and Air Conditioning for you. Getting you set for the summertime, too. Making sure your HVAC is good to go with that cool for the hot summer months ahead. Also, if you need to change your pace, John and Chris Love understand this. You can get $600 off the purchase of a high-efficiency air conditioning system right now. $600 off at 317-353-2141. Also, the state-of-the-art air purification system, iWave, get $125 off just by mentioning my name. Love Heating and Air, 317-353-2141. Online, love-hvac.com today.
Well, the install of your new Anderson 400 series windows is done. They look great. Piece of cake to install. I have them in my own home.
We love them, John.
Beautiful.
They really last, so you won't be needing me to fix anything either. This is probably goodbye. Take care.
That was a tough goodbye. Worse than when the kids went to college.
I love our windows, but John was our contractor.
Anderson 400 series are the windows contractors trust most. Learn more at AndersonWindows.com. 2020 Anderson Brand Survey of U.S. Contractors. Visit AndersonWindows.com for warranty details.
If High Ping takes you from first place to last place, you're not a bad gamer. You just need better internet. Get AT&T Fiber and get a ping rate under 11 milliseconds and unlimited data. With 20 times faster upload speeds, AT&T Fiber delivers a faster internet experience than cable. Limited availability in select areas. Call 1-877-ONLY-ATT. Speed comparison based on AT&T Internet 1000 wired upload connection speed versus major cable providers 1 gig service with uploads of 35 megabits per second. Speeds vary, not guaranteed. Restrictions apply.
During a normal year, moms do it all. They're superhuman. But this year, moms took on so much more. They kept us safe, kept our hopes up, and kept everyone going. And that's on top of all the other superhuman mom stuff. So this Mother's Day, shop Helzberg Diamonds and make Mother's Day extra special for her. We have a large selection of meaningful gifts for every budget, so our associates can help you find the perfect gift to show how much you truly appreciate her. Visit your local Helzberg store or Helzberg.com. Don't forget your special mom this year, Sunday, May 9th.
Hey, John here from my friends, Forum Credit Union. Kevin and the gang today got to remind you of this. It's something that my daughter and I do every month here to help, help set up a college fund for your child. It is called the Sprout Account. And every month we give away $100 in a starter for your child's Sprout account. All you got to do is enter. Seriously, it's that easy. Open up account and then start the savings. And, man, it is awesome how much you can save. Oh, so many years leading up to when you're kids. You don't think about it at the early stages, right? But later on, you should. Making sure they're prepared financially for college. That's Forum Credit Union. Check out Kevin and the gang at a branch location and ask about the Sprout account today or online for all the information you need. ForumCU.com today.
Big O Tires knows tire and auto repair can be an unexpected expense. That's why they have financing options available so you pay nothing today. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Coming up Thursday morning on the Fan Morning Show with Jeff and Big Joe, we'll follow up on that latest report from ESPN on the future of Nate Bjorkgren, plus more on the Colts. 7 a.m. sharp on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
I got nowhere else to go!
93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Yeah, thank you for joining us today, Kevin Bowen, top of the hour. Yeah, we've been talking about the Pacers situation. And the Adrian Wojnarowski story from last night that began with a couple of tweets. First one is follows, if you're not privy to it, amid a year of difficulties with players and staff. Pacers coach Nate Bjorkgren, his future with the franchise uncertain as the regular season nears an end. Continued, Bjorkgren has work to do on relationships with key players in his locker room. All right, I'm curious about this. And Kyle and I were just talking about it. And this is a wild-ass theory, and do with it what you want. And I'm not implicating either side. This is just a, as I mentioned, a wild-ass theory. So with the player news for the Pacers, with the player news, the Miles Turner injury, all the Vic stuff, what else? What other player stuff?
I think he was first on the TJ Warren is going to be out indefinitely, if my memory serves correctly.
Right. So Shams seems to be the player plugged in of the NBA newsbreakers, right?
At least for the Pacers, yeah.
Seems like. So you think it's coming from a different direction with Wojnarowski?
Well, you wonder if it came from the players. Why didn't Shams have it?
Anybody else out there, and it's okay if you say, man, that is dumb as hell. That's all right. It's not the first time, and it will not be the last. But if it this were a player situation, would Shams, whatever his name is, Sharnia, would he have had this first? Hey, listen, I know the loudest voice in NBA breaking news coverage is that easily of Adrian Wojnarowski, but as we bring up, most of this Pacers stuff, player-wise, has been broken by Shams. I mean, is that organizationally? Or is it just a stupid theory? As I told you about as we came back from break. It's a thought. Kevin Bowen coming up top of the hour. Bobby Marks a little bit earlier. Will Fries, who was drafted in round 7 by the Colts over the weekend, joined us also a little bit earlier today. Podcast H1075TheFan.com. Give me Chris on line 4 at 239-1070. Hello, Chris.
Hey, how's it going, JMV?
Great, Chris. Go ahead.
I've been a Pacers season ticket holder for 9 years, missed 2 games. And it's to the point where, like, I have almost no desire to even go to the games anymore. My thought is, I think Pritchard's got to go. I don't know about the coach. I think he's not very good. But at the end of the day, do you think the Pacers can actually, when I say win here, can they win big here? Can they win a title? Is it the owner? Like, you got to spend money at the end of the day. So, are our hopes too high? Hope you have a good day, buddy.
I got you. I appreciate you. Are hopes too high? And I think, you should have expectations. I mean, this is basketball in this state. I mean, would you always like to see ownership, you know, go as far as they can financially? Yeah. I mean, have they paid big contracts? Sure. You know, they go as far as others? No. Is this a challenging market for the NBA to get anybody to want to come here and play? Absolutely it is. Has this team had success in the past? Sure they have. It's always going to be my expectations. I don't know about anybody else. Hey, listen. I would not be talking about this at length if I didn't care. I do. I love watching the NBA. I love watching basketball, and I do care about this. And I just thought that whoever decided to go ahead and float out that info to Wojnarowski last night embarrassed everybody by it. And it makes it look like a clown show. So Skivvies writes this. So Kevin Pritchard talks to Wojnarowski. The agents talk to Shams. It was just a theory. But if you look back on it, it looks like Shams always has the Pacer player info first. It's just a thid, and it's not like I have to buy it. I just floated it out there because you just kind of want to know where this is coming from and why. And they set the stage to get rid of Nate Bjorkgren after one season. Kind of sounds that way. If you're on hold, I'll get back to you. Kevin Bowen's going to join us coming up on the other side. I got Luke Bryan tickets at some point in hour number three. You're going to get a chance at that August the 20th show at Ruoff Home Mortgage Music Center. Thank you to our friends at Live Nation. Tomorrow, I've got Hawks and Pacers tickets for you at District Tap coming up tomorrow. Downtown with Coors Light, 93.5, 107.5, and 1070 The Fan.
My name is Bill McQueen, and I own Perry Acoustics, a construction company here in the great state of Indiana. Each year, some construction companies misclassify their employees as independent contractors and illegally pay them cash under the table. That puts companies like mine that pay a good living wage and employee benefits at a major competitive disadvantage. These companies rob our state of over $400 million a year. Imagine what could be done for Hoosiers with that money.
Visit IndianaCIP.com/tax fraud to learn how together we can tell them to stop stealing from Hoosiers.
Hey, it's John, and Mother's Day is almost here. After all she's been through in the last 12 months, how about something really, as Cousin Eddie once said, really nice, special? Can I suggest my friends at Diamonds Direct? They put together an incredible collection of Mother's Day gifts. Gifts, in fact, that are timeless and meaningful and that she can enjoy for years. Diamond earrings, stackable rings, birthstone rings, earrings with colored gemstones, eternity bands, pendants, pearls. Maybe you commemorate this Mother's Day with a new center diamond for an engagement ring. Man, whatever the case, if you want to go big and make it extra special, this is the place. It's Diamonds Direct online. That's DiamondsDirect.com. Diamonds Direct for Mother's Day. Keystone into Crossing.
Hi, I'm Ryan Kelly with HeroLoan.com. VA interest rates can be up to a full point lower than conventional loans, saving you hundreds of dollars a month. You can buy a house with no money down, and there's almost never a loan limit on VA loans. VA rates are in the twos, and we're saving our clients hundreds, even thousands of dollars a month. Get the service that you deserve and apply online today at HeroLoan.com. That's HeroLoan.com, the only way to VA.
The Home Loan Expert LLC, NMLS number 1326241.
Does have it all. Savings, service, selection, and a whole lot more. All of our pre-owned vehicles are Hubler Q certified. Every Q certified vehicle includes a 128-point vehicle inspection, a free Carfax vehicle history report, and not one, but two warranties. A 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and a 30-day, 1,000-mile comprehensive warranty. But that's not all. Each Q certified vehicle on our lot has fewer than 100,000 miles. Or is less than 9 years old. Looking to sell your car? Hubler will pay top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Come see why Hoosiers have trusted Hubler for 60 years. Visit any of our 13 locations today or click drivehubler.com.
Hubler has it all.
Bet Rivers Sportsbook has supercharged its app for Apple phones. And you can download the update today from the iOS App Store. Loaded with performance improvements, the new Bet Rivers iOS app makes placing your bets a seamless experience. Bet with a winner. Download the new Bet Rivers app from the iOS App Store or update your app today. Must be 21 or over to play. Playable only in Indiana. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
For the biggest selection of Mother's Day gifts, shop Cynthia's Hallmark at 116th and Allisonville Road, 116th and Brook School Road, 96th and Lantern Road in Fishers, and in Greenfield.
Jeff Bassett here with Bassett Services. We are here to take care of you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We may doze, but we never close.
Bassett is your trusted local independent American Standard Air dealer.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WFNI, WIBC, HD2, W298BB, WIBC, HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Pacers return home to play the Sacramento Kings tonight at 7:30 on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
Thank you for your support.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Hey, let me tell you this. You're not believable as a country music artist or duo if you don't say Wenders instead of Windows there, all right? Roll my winders down. Winders, not windows. Yeah, that is not Luke Bryan for everybody calling right now. Luke Bryan tickets. When you hear a Luke Bryan reentry, that is the mostly tatted up duo known as Florida Georgia Line. Winders. Colts signed linebacker Malik Jefferson. And in case you were wondering, that is not the son of former Ridgemont High School linebacker Charles Jefferson. Malik Jefferson, drafted in the third round 2018 by the Bengals, 13 games with the Chargers last year. And he's going to compete. They want competition. I have not heard if you're asking regarding Eric Fisher. Here's the thing, though. Charles Leno all the way. I'm just assuming at this point, and we'll ask Kevin Bowen when we bring him on here, I'm assuming that unless you have some sort of connection to like the Chiefs or the Eagles, I guess in free agency, most of the time you're not going to be brought in, I'm guessing here. Via the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline, is that how this is going to go down? Is it going to be Fisher over Leno in your opinion?
Yeah, I think if the medical checks out, it'll be Fisher.
So do you think it's more of the Chiefs connection or that the Colts somehow, some way, most of the time also have to bring in an injured player? What do you think? Which one is it?
Not only an injured player, but a torn Achilles, because that seems to be the common injury lately.
Right.
I think there's just a little bit of a higher ceiling. I mean, trust me, I totally get where you're coming from on Leno and the durability, and honestly – on the offensive line, you take durability over anything. But if healthy in a vacuum, obviously Fisher, I think, is the better player than Charles Leno. But, you know, it's not only the torn Achilles with Fisher, John. I mentioned it yesterday when this news was announced of him coming to visit. You know, he missed half the 2019 season, Eric Fisher, with a core injury. So, you know, this is not just a guy that has been – I mean, he was very healthy his first five seasons. But now that he's reaching the age of 30 – there's been a couple of injuries that have really, really sidelined him. So, again, I think if the medicals check out, it would be Fisher over Leno. But we'll see how that plays out. And
what do you think? What do you think? Should it be Leno or Fisher or Leno or anybody else in your opinion? Because to me, I thought that was a gift. And while this guy may not be the greatest left tackle of all time, he's had a great ability, and that's availability. And everybody always says, Kev, hey, it doesn't matter who you stick at left tackle with that offensive line, they're going to make him great. I mean, how hard is it going to be to make him better than he even was in Chicago? And his season a year ago wasn't bad if he came down here and manned the left tackle position for a year or two.
Well, I would argue, how good did Jazz Green or Raven Clark look next to Quentin Nelson? Like, I know it's kind of a popular thing that people have said, oh yeah, next to Quentin Nelson, you know, you're gonna look great.
But this guy had a good year last year, though. I mean, he wasn't Jazz Green or Raven Clark. I mean, he had a good year, comparable to the number crunching nerds tell me, Kev, that he had a season comparable to Costanzo.
Yeah, and I guess to take it a step further with the nerd aspect to it, the one thing that might cause the Colts hesitancy is Charles Leno is 6'3 and like 305. Now, again, he's played left tackle in the NFL at a pretty respectable level, I think, especially for being a seventh round pick. But 6'3, 307 is not making any sort of measurable requirement for the Indianapolis Colts at offensive tackle. Now, they make exceptions, obviously, Kenny Moore being one of those at corner. But that is another aspect, I think, to weigh in this, just like, you know, are they steadfast in that, well, 6'3", you know, I don't know. Again, that might sound stupid, and maybe they're not. Maybe they're like, hey, this guy's put good tape at the NFL level on. I would probably side with Leno just because I'm at the point right now with left tackle, just like, what's going to make me sleep easiest at night? And his availability would make me sleep easier than a guy coming off a torn Achilles. That's where I would be, because the more this becomes a constant issue, I think the more stress you put on Carson Wentz, and that's not what you need coming into this season.
Before we get to the Pacers, and I'm going to spend ample time on what I think is a clown show after last night with you in just a second, but where you come off in thinking about this draft and the work that was done over the weekend by the hometowners?
You know, I was saying on Monday morning, John, my issue at left tackle isn't as much to do with this draft because, again, you only had two picks in the first, 125. But my main issue is really revolving around how you tried to succeed Anthony Costanzo at left tackle. And I just think it was a total I don't even know what the plan was, to be honest with you. I mean, 2 years ago, Costanzo, has some injuries. He's reaching the end of his contract. He reaches the age of 30. And they never even really attempted to draft tackle, certainly not with any meaningful draft pick. And once you start thinking about retirement, you know full well that guy's walking out the door earlier than you would like for him to walk out the door. So, again, I don't have as much of a gripe with, like, oh, my gosh, it shouldn't have been Dayo Odengbo. You know, you should have traded up for left tackle. Like, this to me is like a multi-year issue, just call all kind of boiling over last week. As far as the draft itself, I mean, I totally understand the approach and wanting to really turn over a new leaf on the defensive line. You've missed there at those draft picks, and you need to get more stout and I think a little bit more, kind of just inject some new life into the edge rush. So I totally understand that. If Odengbo's healthy, and you hear New York Giant defensive linemen, whether that's, Pierre Paul, Justin Tuck, something like that, I mean, that certainly is a guy that you would love to have moving forward. I like Kylan Granson, the tight end out of SMU. I think he's the right type of tight end as well. So, again, for the most part, I was good with it, but the whole left tackle thing, it's just been a botched sort of succession plan for Anthony Costanzo.
But it's okay now because Leno's available. That's why they should be jumping on it.
Well, I mean,
that makes it okay. That makes it all right.
Again, okay for now. But, like, Charles Leno's what, 30 years old? I mean, it's
29,
still
right?
The fact that it's still the fact that there's just never been a long-term sort of plan there post-Costanzo. And it cost you last year. Late in the season when you had to scramble. And now, like you said, you're reliant on a gift from Chicago. So that would be probably my main issue. I don't know how much, again, of a draft-centric issue it is. Part of it, I think, comes back to just Chris's general philosophy in the offseason. And I know, I think Rick Venturi and you talked about this, but I was talking with Rick about it. When you don't use free agency to the level that they – choose not to use it, you put so much pressure on the draft, and that's where I felt like they could have made a move on the defensive line and free agency to where maybe you don't walk into the draft and think, oh, wow, first two picks, we really want to use that on defensive line. Because honestly, I think that was largely the approach and the thinking that Chris Ballard had entering the draft.
Well, that's funny because they went from everybody talking about how deep that position was, and I do know that there were a run-on pick, but it went from a lot of depth to we don't like anybody here pretty damn quick.
Yeah, and Chris says after the draft, the prototypical left tackle, I guess that kind of gets back to the whole Leno thing. Now, again, I think when a guy's established 6 or 7 years in the league, you kind of throw out measurables and combine stuff and things like that. If a guy's proven he can play on Sundays, the guy can play on Sundays. But I think how Chris views it is if I'm going to spend that type of draft pick, on a left tackle, you've got to meet some pretty, big-time requirements for them. And really, they've never drafted an offensive tackle under Ballard. I guess Zach Banner would be the only one in the first 4 or 5 rounds. I mean, Braden Smith was never drafted to be a tackle, and he had, short arms, and that was the reason why they thought he was such a guard. So I think that played into some of it as well, as while it was a deep tackle class, I mean, the Colts were really stringent in a lot of measurables, and they clearly felt like there weren't maybe as many left tackles as some other teams thought.
So do you think, in closing with this, it was more important for them to address, and obviously with pay available, you hit the jackpot at 21. There's no question about that.
Right.
But it, to me, especially after talking to Jim on this show, I mean, he put everything, he really did, everything focus-wise on the quarterback position and what Carson Wentz is going to be next year as that equates to the level of success this team has. And that's why I thought, to me, you bring in as many support staff members, as many helpers as you can offensively to make sure that you have the best opportunity for that level of success. And that's just going by what the owner said. Now, honestly, and you know this as well, what the owner says is normally the complete opposite of what Chris does. You know what? I mean, it normally is when you look at it.
Right. Yeah, Jim's telling you corner is a need, and then they don't draft the corner at all.
Well, I mean, yeah, that, and left. He talks about left tackle, and they don't, you know. I mean, he talks about, we're ready to win multiple now, and Chris says the window is just now opening. I mean, it's always opposite.
Yeah, there's a lot of debate, I think, leading into the draft. Left tackle, edge rusher, what was the biggest need?
Yeah.
For me, it was left tackle, because if you don't have a left tackle, your quarterback can get killed. If you don't have an edge rusher, well, yeah, that might hurt your football team, but your quarterback's not going to get killed. Like, literally, if you're poor at left tackle, a QB that has, finished one season healthy in his NFL career, maybe two, I don't have it in front of me, but a guy that's had some injuries in his career, I want to make sure that I keep him, as to your earlier point, as supported as possible. And I know support, listening to you, certainly, you were hoping for Terrence Marshall there in the second round, but support can be, pass protection as well. So I just feel like that has been a miss this off season of, you look at left tackle, you look at receiver, you look at tight end. Yes, I guess bringing back Marlon Mack, but I guess who knows with the Achilles, but you look at the pass catchers and you look at the left tackle, those three kind of big needs, a re-sign of Hilton and patchwork tackles and Kylan Granson, is that enough support? I don't know. And I also think you're putting a little bit on Frank Reich's plate, too. He's going to have to scheme up, helping out that left tackle. And it's one thing when Phillip Rivers is quick rhythm. It's a little bit easier to do. I think Carson, ideally, wants to hold on to it a little bit longer.
Yeah, and, listen. The only reason I ever bring up wide receiver is because every stinking year during the season, that becomes an issue, no matter what. And it'll probably happen again this year. Hey, anyway, we'll move on from that because I've asked about Zach Ertz enough. And we talked about the tight end that they selected in round four. I want to double to the Pacers thing that I brought up earlier, double back to what I brought up earlier. I thought last night with what Wojnarowski put out there really was embarrassing. I did. I mean, consider everything that's gone down, and now you have what looks to be dissension in the ranks. Where would you suggest that came from? I mean, was it a player? Was it within the organization? Where do you think that nugget of info that went to Wojnarowski absolutely was created by? Where was it?
That's a good question. I would guess player, right? I mean, boy, if you're Kevin Pritchard leaking that to Woj, you don't look very good. You hired the man, and if you think he should be fired, you probably should be fired, to be honest with you. So I would assume players. That was my first assumption, and then I thought to myself.
If it were a player, because Kyle and I were talking about this, and this is going to be a bad theory, but the players, Shams always gets the player stuff first, seems like, with the Pacers, in mind. It always seems that way. I mean, we look back on it. I mean, all the latest, the recent players' news from the Pacers.
It's certainly Victor.
Comes from him. Yeah. Well, I mean, Victor and then Miles' injury. And what else were you talking about over there, Kyle? It just kind of – it's just a really bad theory, I'm sure, but it's a theory nonetheless.
Yeah, I know Shams had a little bit more today than I guess Woj first had it last night. But, My first thought, John, is since one of these Pacers players, LeBron or insert star,
no question about it,
they get one player, one coach fired last year,
and they've already hired the. Yeah, this is
they might be.
This is their choice.
This guy fired again.
This is their choice.
They acted like he was John Wooden a week or two into the season, and then all of a sudden, some adversity hits. T.J. Warren gets hurt, and now they want to push him out the door. So. By no means am I saying Nate Bjorkman's absolved from all this, but boy, players in the locker room again, stop whining and all of this. And I think there's a level of just kind of manning up and having a conversation and realizing, this is a first-time NBA head coach. It's a wild year with COVID. Nate has been dealt an awful hand injury-wise, and I think you just have a very, you know, whatever.
Well, I mean, he stunk too, though. Regardless of what you're saying, he's not been good either. I mean, he just hasn't. Well, he hasn't been good. And he clearly lets these guys, it seems like he gets walked on a lot. He's got his face in an iPad all the time. So he's not covered himself in glory by any stretch.
He is not, but let's not absolve the players or Kevin Pritchard either.
No. And I'm not. I'm not. This crap can't happen. I mean, this crap can't. It's already hard enough for anybody to ever want to come here anyway. And then you get this bull crap. And I'm sick of it. I mean, because really the thing, Kev, we've talked about the most about this team in recent memory, it's soap opera. It's drama. And I'm sick of it. I mean, I am.
Yeah, and this is vastly different drama than, you know, Paul and Victor being a little bit more individually related. I mean, this is you push Nate out the door. And I also think we need to hear from Kevin Pritchard in some of this. You know, this is something to where when Kevin fired Nate last year, you know, just weeks after giving him a contract extension, you don't hear from him for a couple of days. Trade deadline this year, the TJ Warren news comes out that day, you don't hear from him. Then, you know, he does the thing with Kravitz, and that's a little bit run into, I think, you know, one individual not meeting everybody there. And then this stuff comes out. And, you know, if Kevin had the issue, I feel like you would have heard some of that in that Kravitz Athletic Q&A a few weeks ago.
What if you just want to lay the groundwork, though? What if you're laying the groundwork of preparing folks for a one-and-done scenario? What if you're doing that? Just, I mean, again, do I believe it? No. But I'm just throwing it out there.
Yeah, but, like, what groundwork do you need to lay 2 weeks before the end of the season? I mean, I agree with you.
Like, that's why I said earlier, regardless of what happened, I mean, I think everybody sees what they see here. You know what I mean? I mean, you see what's going on. I mean, you know what's going on. You know everything doesn't fit. You know you're going to have to make changes. You know the coach hasn't been great. You know the personnel needs to be upgraded, changed without a doubt here. You can't run this thing back. Unfortunately, I think this just embarrasses folks, and in embarrassment helps solidify what everybody's already seen anyway, or what everybody's already checked out from, Kev, to this point.
Yeah, and I know, you know, Kevin is very big on catering to players. Like, he's a big believer in that, and I think he's gone a little overboard in that. I get it. It's difficult in this market to acquire players, but when you're letting those players make decisions like this and you know, run the organization, for lack of a better term, that's not a healthy, you know, business whatsoever. Especially when these players, again, are not top 10, top 15 players in the league. I mean, hell, Malcolm Brogdon's not even a top 40 player in the NBA. Like, it's a little bit confusing to me that they have Kevin Zier this much. And, you know, it's one thing with the Nate McMillan when you see the playoff record and all of that. But I do think there's a level of just, you know, if you fire Bjorkman after 1 year, I mean, what's that message going to send to potential coaching candidates around the league? Like, you know, COVID year, I mean, he has been, got to be honest with this, he's been dealt an injury hand that was far worse than anything Nate McMillan was handed. I mean, Warren played 5 games. You didn't have Oladipo or LeVert.
What if they want to let a potential coach know that this job is going to be open right now? Just out of curiosity, getting us throwing stuff out there.
Are we talking to Boston?
I mean, just out of curiosity.
Yeah. You know, part of me would say, why wasn't that coach hired in the first place? Like, if you were this enamored with another coach potentially.
I guess trying to make sense of it makes us all look a little silly, because it doesn't make any sense.
Fire Bjorkren, you got to fire Pritchard.
I agree.
He went out on a ledge. I thought it was the right move to fire McMillan. The argument about hiring Bjorkren, I can certainly listen to, definitely. But I thought it was time, given the playoff non-success, given the fact that you just aren't very innovative. So I thought that was the right move, but you look at the draft record, and now you look at this potential debacle that you're going down. I don't know. And I know, you know, Kevin Pritchard's got the Simons, you know, wrapped around his finger. So that's a great thing for him, but if you're going to fire Nate Bjorken after 1 year, then you got to start the whole thing over.
I agree, and I started off the show saying, I mean, at some point, the finger has been pointed at everybody, except one. So that's the final. That's it right there. I mean, that's going to be it.
Yeah, and you know this. I'm always curious just how much was the personnel forced down Nate Bjorken's throat. And I know it probably comes out like I'm making a lot of excuses for Bjorken, but you know, the whole like, oh, two bigs in Toronto. No, they never played Ibaka and Gasol together for long, long stretches. Like that was always just kind of confusing to me. And it almost in a way, and I know there it's different titles, I guess, but it almost feels like Pagano Ballard in 2017, where here's Chris Ballard walking in. He wants to draft personnel for a different defense, different culture, all of this. And yet his head coach is trying to save his job, running a totally different defense than his general manager wants. Well, now it's here's the personnel, Nate Bjorken, but you want to, you know, run a defense and you want to play, you know, super fast in a much, much different way than I think your personnel would be best, whatever, utilized by. And now some of it is Bjorken, hey, look, this is the personnel that you're given. You need to make adjustments. But part of it is, are you instilling a system, installing, you know, different things offensively and defensively, and you want some of your young guys to grow with that, even if, you know, some of your older guys, it might not be the perfect fit for them.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like a mess. And that was my point, as well as I think everybody sees that right now. I mean, everybody sees that there are mismatched parts. And, you know, this philosophy from the coach is not going to work with this group. And, I mean, you always think, especially about this, 1 year or not, it is much easier, especially for the Pacers, to, you know, adjust the head coaching situation and that philosophy than it would be trying to you know, with bits and pieces, make deals to bring different bodies in here. It just would be. So, but I agree with you. And the other thing, and I know, Kev, you probably have received this too. Everybody says, well, they should have kept Nate McMillan. Nate McMillan would have already been fired. I mean, to me, right, he would have already been let go. I mean, the players didn't want him. The players would have already revolted that, especially with the injuries and what is, you know, the path this team has taken. He'd already be gone.
Yeah. You think the Simons would you know, fire him after a year? I mean, they've never done that in their history.
I know.
Pacers, it's pandemic. I mean, how much money have you made?
It is always so important for them to make the postseason. I mean, that's always declared every year to make the postseason. How angry are they if they don't in this case? I mean, even with the whole dog and pony show the NBA postseason has become. How angry are they if they don't?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's, I mean, that's very fair. I don't know. It just seems like a rather drastic thing to do. And I get it. The Bjorken resume wasn't anything to sell season tickets over. But, I mean, man, some of these injuries, it's – and I mean, trust me, I've heard some stories, John, where you're like, wait, Nate Bjorken's doing that? Like, it's – I mean, there's reasons, obviously, that Woj came out with that report, and Shams clearly backed it up as well. So by no means am I, you know, letting Bjorken off the hook. But, you know, to me, this is not Frank Vogel, tired voice. Like, that was just a horrible decision by Larry Bird. This is like, got to give the guy, I would think, another chance. Just in a normal year, normal offseason, make some tweaks personnel-wise, or else, again, if you think he's got to go, then Kevin Pritchard's got to go.
What's the let's just say this. What's more of the message to the fans? I mean, what would they receive better? Just living with it from one more year and firing this thing back up again, or realizing you made a mistake and going a different direction? What would resonate more with the fan base here?
That's a good one. Probably firing him. I don't agree with that, but yeah, probably firing.
That's probably an unfair question to ask, because most of the time, people want change, and yeah.
Yeah, people want it, and Nate obviously, like, yeah, I mean, the jokes kind of write themselves. From, he sounds like my mom recapping some of my golf matches in high school with how positive he is after games they lose by 30, and then the whole iPad thing and whatnot, and now the players, whatever, semi-revolting on him. So I think if you are able to, you know, whatever, I think in a perfect world, you miss the playoffs, you get a lottery pick, see what happens there. You make some tweaks personnel-wise, you get Brogdon off the ball, and then you see what you have next year. And I go back to the whole financial thing. I mean, you're paying two head coaches this year. You're going to be paying two head coaches next year if you fire him. I think that's another real conversation. It would be very against the norm for the Simons and the Pacers to do such a move. Now, having said that, firing Nate McMillan was a bit against the norm as well. So,
hey, if you're a coach, you know, would you want to – I mean, I know you're going to get paid a lot, but how interesting would this job be if you know that this group of dudes have gotten two coaches fired in a calendar year?
Right. Yeah. I mean, literally, my first question would be, like, I get Malcolm Brogdon, you know, could be the president one day, but is he running the show here? Or, like, again, this is Malcolm Brogdon, folks. This is not LeBron James or Giannis here. That would literally be the question, which is unfortunate because the Pacers are already at a lot of disadvantages in acquiring talent. That would be a big, big issue for me. And, I mean, I guess I'm assuming it's just Brogdon. I don't know how much is it a Sabonis thing. I mean, no one in that locker room.
Why? I said this earlier, though, Kev. Why would they complain? Brogdon gets everything that he wants and has. Sabonis' numbers are through the roof. They play through him completely. Who would have an issue in that locker room? Who would?
Yeah.
Who should have an issue other than being embarrassed by the beatdown they took the other night? But who would have an issue? I can't find one.
Not only who would have the issue, but, like, who deserves to have an issue and air it so publicly?
Like, yeah, I mean, I don't even go that far. I just said who should. I mean,
yeah.
Miles, you know, was defensive player of the year before his toe injury, or thought he was, at least, or was in the conversation. Who would have an issue?
Like Miles, I mean, even a month ago, Miles was still routinely praising how this coaching staff, you know, utilizes him and whatnot. So, I mean, yeah.
I don't know who it would be. I mean, and you're right. I mean, who would – you know, who besides the ones we've already mentioned would bring even a reasonable level of consideration?
And there's not like there's this like 12-year vet in that locker room that's been in, you know, it was so respected around the league. I don't even know who I'm trying to think of. Like the name coming to my head, which is not a good one, is Darrell Armstrong. But, you know, like some just very respected guy around
David
the
West.
League
that, David West with this team.
Yes. I was thinking a much worse player than David West. But, yeah, somebody like that has that type of respect with, you know, with Woj or Shams or whatnot. So,
I was talking about a voice in the locker room that would be trusted like that or that would carry a little bit of weight. And, I mean, clearly Brogdon does, but I don't know why this dude would be complaining about anything.
Like, I can't imagine Justin Holiday calling Shams, you know, whatever.
Right.
Justin Holiday's agent calling Shams and being like, hey, listen to this, and all of a sudden them running with it. Like, you got to have some, you know, whatever, starting level talent. So,
all right,
unbelievable. But
I got to run.
People
think I want to piss and moan about this, and I don't, man. I do not want to do it. I just thought last night was one of the bad moments of a bad season here. I mean, I think it really was. And whoever's responsible for it, I'd just love to know why, because it makes no sense. Right.
You already just had an embarrassing effort like none other on the court Monday, and then to have it off the court as well just adds insult to injury.
All right, man. I appreciate you as always. And, a shout-out to go call Chris when you get off the phone here and tell him to get Charles Leno Jr., all right?
Oh, boy, yeah. I'm sure he
will listen to you
right away. Yeah, definitely.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate you.
All right.
It's Bowen, Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Quick one. We'll come back with your calls, and we got Luke Bryan tickets. I think we've kind of whittled this down. You've got less than 30 with me right now. At some point, somebody's going to win those tickets for the show in August. I'll explain next.
It's no secret that the housing market is red hot. Get a leg up on the competition and get pre-approved now. TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
Hey, it's JMV. Join me live coming up tomorrow afternoon from 3 until 6. We're going to be live at the District Tap downtown with Coors Light and your chance to go see the Hawks and the Pacers later on in the evening at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. All right, you know about the Atlanta Hawks, right? Eastern Conference, one of the better teams we have seen since former Pacers head coach Nate McMillan has taken over. All right, he took the job on an interim basis, and this team has been as good as anybody. You're going to see superstar Trae Young, and you're going to go on us, courtesy of Coors Light, to see the Hawks and the Pacers at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. And all you have to do is stop by the District Tap downtown with me between 3 and 6 and get signed up for your chance to be at that game coming up tomorrow night. Hawks and Pacers, and you can be there live at the District Tap tomorrow from 3 until 6 with Coors Light, 93.5, 107.5, and 1070 The Fan.
The regular season is coming to a close and only a few games left to cheer on your Indiana Pacers live inside Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
They give it to Sabonis.
Score and a foul! DeMontis Sabonis!
Single game Pacer tickets are on sale, and a safe fan experience is our top priority.
Brogdon for three.
Got it! Malcolm Brogdon!
The Pacers continue their playoff push when the Sacramento Kings come to town. Get tickets at Pacers.com.
Oh, baby!
Pacers, Kings, Wednesday at 8.
Hey, Johnny, for L.D. Smith Plumbing, shout out to Lance and his local team at 317-284-9526. I don't know how your sump pump is doing, because clearly I haven't been in your house to see your sump pump, but I will tell you this. You recognize when we get a lot of moisture, and I know it is clear outside right now, but I guess it's supposed to rain again tomorrow. We had a lot of rain prior to today. Make sure your sump pump's doing its job. If it's not, get it checked up with my friends Lance and his team, the local folks at LD Smith Plumbing at 317-284-9526. Nothing too large, nothing too small. Right now, a great deal on a tankless water heater, $300 off. Just by mentioning my name, a tankless water heater for your home with LD Smith Plumbing, 317-284-9526. Lance and his team online, ldsmithplumbing.com today.
Hubler has it, savings. Hubler has it, choices. Hubler has it all.
Hubler really does have it all. Savings, service, selection, and a whole lot more. All of our pre-owned vehicles are Hubler Q certified. Every Q certified vehicle includes a 128-point vehicle inspection, a free Carfax vehicle history report, and not one, but two warranties. A 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and a 30-day, 1,000-mile comprehensive warranty. But that's not all. Each Q certified vehicle on our lot has fewer than 100,000 miles or is less than 9 years old. Looking to sell your car? Hubler will pay top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Come see why Hoosiers have trusted Hubler for 60 years. Visit any of our 13 locations today or click drivehubler.com.
Hubler has it all.
Hey, it's JMV for Kinetico Water Systems and my friends Joe, John, and Dennis. And this promise, a Kinetico Premier Series water softener filters out all the bad stuff in water that makes it hard, leaving you with all that clean, soft, and safe water that you know and that you want and you love with my friends at Kinetico. Call today, tell them you heard it from me, get an additional $200 off your purchase. That's great. That's Kinetico. Online now, kineticoindy.com.
Ah, it's finally time to get outside. But it's also the time when new or old injuries can start up. You know, that nagging tightness in your hips or those strains in your knee. Maybe it's also the time to start Athletico Physical Therapy. Instead of going to your doctor first, start with physical therapy. With no prescription needed, their team of experts will find the source of your pain and start healing it before it progresses, so you can finally live pain-free.
It all starts at Athletico Physical Therapy. Schedule your free assessment with athletico.com. No prescription needed in most states.
Amazon is hiring near you. Looking for team members who know that their work is important and that every package matters. Find a job that fits your life with competitive wages, reliable hours, and benefits. Let's work together, from boxing it up to sending it on its way. Every step offers a different role and schedule. So, are you ready to work together in your community? Visit amazon.com/apply to see what's available. That's amazon.com/apply. Amazon is an equal opportunity employer.
T-Mobile is bringing 5G from big cities to small towns across America. We've been investing billions to light up our award-winning 5G network in more places than ever. And to celebrate, we're upgrading everyone to 5G. Introducing the free 5G upgrade. It's time to upgrade your phone and your plan. Bring any working cell phone to T-Mobile and trade it in for a free 5G Samsung Galaxy. Plus, when you switch, you'll get unlimited 5G for the same price as Verizon and AT&T's limited plans. Now that's an upgrade. And just one of the reasons why T-Mobile is America's leader in 5G. Experience it today with a free 5G upgrade. Visit a neighborhood store or T-Mobile.com to learn more.
Phone via 24 credits plus tax. If you cancel, credit stop and balance on required finance agreement may be due. Contact us. Qualifying credit required. Plan with auto pay plus taxes and fees. Customers on this plan may notice speeds lower than other customers and further reduction if using over 50 gigs a month due to data prioritization. Video streams at 480p. See T-Mobile.com.
Circle K is America's thirst stop. And yours. Especially when the weather gets... and you need to stay... stay refreshed on the go with ice-cold Circle K favorites like freshly ground iced coffee, Froster, Polar Pop Cup, and more. And right now at Circle K, save on all 8 or 12-ounce Red Bull flavors. Buy two, get one free. When life's go, 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 make us your first stop. Because Circle K is America's thirst stop.
Do you need air conditioning service and are looking for a local dealer you can trust like Marshall Mechanical in Franklin? Find that American Standard Air dealer at IndyHomeComfort.com.
Hey, JMV, time for today's soccer scoreboard update brought to you by the Indy 11 home opener, Carroll Stadium, Saturday night, 7 o'clock, FC Tulsa, the competition. Tickets available, Indy11.com. Earlier today, on the road in Spain, Chelsea 2, Real Madrid 0. That's your soccer scoreboard update. Brought to you by the Indy 11. Carroll Stadium, the site, Saturday, the time, 7 p.m. versus FC Tulsa. That's your home opener. Tickets available right now. Get them, Indy11.com.
The Ride with JMV.
Well, you're going to have to say that. You're going to have to speak up because I can't hear you.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Hey, by the way, Pacers and Kings tonight. Let's see if the Pacers come out with any fire or from Southern Indiana like me, Farr. Will they come out with any far later on tonight? The Kings and the Pacers, 7:30, your pregame coverage right here. Tomorrow night, 7:30 the same. I'm going to be at District Tap. I've got tickets to give away for the game. Is Trae Young playing tomorrow night? Do we know for sure? Is he still hurt? Is he hurt? I don't, because I just heard that commercial play and I thought about that. At any rate, tomorrow, District Tap, join me with Coors Light, and we shall have a blast. Stan has been on hold the longest. Stan, you're on the show. Hello.
Alan, I appreciate it. It's about the Pacers, what I was calling about. It goes back to what Larry Bird said a long time ago about these players want to get paid and what the owners are willing and not willing to go over and bring in. It's been shown. And with Vic and with Paul George, when we had the opportunity to possibly bring in AD, and we didn't want to, and then Paul George left. So when do we start put to the owners?
I think people have. I mean, to me, I brought this up earlier. The only direction the fingers haven't been pointed around here has been at Kevin. That's it. I mean, everybody else has been criticized for it, for the shortcomings. So
I really thank you, but as a fan, I've been a fan since ABA, and I just got it like this. It's time to start putting the owners where their money is. It's just that time, and I know we have criticized the owners before, but when it all boiled down, it still goes back to the owners. And if we are we just one round and ready to go home, we can't just be that city for that. This is a city of basketball. Sports, really, but
well, man, and certainly they're not going to go in any luxury tax, and that's what you're talking about right there. But certainly that's been brought up. I just think, I mean, if there's any dysfunction and a reason why they feel the need to go ahead and jettison, you know, a first year head coach after this year, then you know that is the decision. That's the decision of Kevin Pritchard, even if he was urged by the players to go in that direction. And it seems like that is an embarrassing level of dysfunction all the way around. If that's the case, even if Nate Bjorkgren hasn't been any good this year as a rookie, so
I would go along with what you said. I've been listening to the whole show since you were talking to the other guy and some of the other people that was on hold for a call, and. It comes to a point that some of these players, they just got to play. You get in your way. You get what you want. And I wouldn't fire the first-year coach neither. You still like you're going to be paying two coaches. So what's the use of firing another one and then hiring another one? And that like you said, this whole situation that got out, it makes us look bad.
It does, Stan. And you know what? Somebody like you and Pacer fans that watch know. They know what they see. I mean, they know what's going on. And you just don't need to – I don't think you need to publicly, nationally embarrass yourself. I guess they're lucky because nobody nationally really cares. But, the people that watch all the time, to me, I don't know what good at all whoever gave up that info last night. I don't know what good it does. It just embarrasses you. To me, Stan, thank you for the call.
Appreciate it.
Randall's up next at 239-1070. Hello, Randall.
Hey, I think we've came to a point. I don't want to blow it up and destroy it and start over, but we need to do some major spring cleaning with a can of whip ass and some major sanitizer. I think it's pretty obvious where the comment came from. It came from the loudest horn in the band, and that's Brogdon, period. He needs to go. We put him with Oladipo. He kind of worked. He didn't work. You know, now he's in a place where he's pretty much the big man on campus, and he's got the loudest voice, and he's stirring it up, and we need to move him. We can get something out of him. Let's move him. Let's trade Miles Turner also. If we can't get rid of him, let's release him, period. Shake his hand. Give him a big hug. We wish you the best luck in the next adventure. Sign your all-star to a long-term deal. It's time that we start respecting. I know that they've all been crying. It's time that we respect these people who make the all-star team and quit letting them fly the coop and go, we wish we would have signed them now 2 or 3 years later.
Yeah, Randall. Sabonis is signed. Sabonis is signed.
How many years? How many years he signed
for? What has he got? 3 years? Three, 4 years remaining, I think.
Okay, add 2 or 3 to it. He's worth it.
Randall, thank you. I got to go, Randall. Thank you very much. Good crapping Lord. They signed him. I think more the point would be if they signed the right guys. And the point about Brogdon is this. I mean, if Brogdon is the source of this, Brogdon was at the front of wanting this change. He was the most vocal. How many more years does Sabonis have?
This was the first year of his extension. He's got 3 more.
I think he's all right. I don't think they'll allow you to sign him to 27 years.
You're not even extension eligible until the year before your free agency. So he couldn't sign one
Yell at me about it, Randall. I'm just going by the book. Quick break and we'll return. A couple of final calls. We'll get in. Tomorrow at the District Tap, let me tell you this. We all need it. So join me at the District Tap tomorrow, and we will throw back some ice-cold Coors Lights and chill out a little bit. Tomorrow, District Tap downtown with Coors Light on 93.5, 107.5, and 1070 The Fan.
Kids, tell your parents about Forum Credit Union's Sprout of the Month contest, where you could win $100 in a Sprout account. Details at 107.5thefan.com.
Big O Tires knows tire and auto repair can be an unexpected expense. That's why they have financing options available, so you pay nothing today. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
You're good at being you. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance is good at your insurance. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Android users, BetRivers Sportsbook is ready for download in the Google Play Store. Just search for BetRivers and download the app. It's never been easier to get in the game. You'll enjoy the ease of use and critical speed of the new BetRivers Android app. Bet with a winner. Download the BetRivers Android app in the Google Play Store today. Must be 21 or over to play. Playable only in Indiana. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Hey, John here. It's for Forum Credit Union. You know, my friends at Forum Credit Union are the absolute best. And May is National 529 Month, and Forum has the perfect way to supplement your child's 529 college account. It's called the Sprout College Savings Account at Forum. It pays a competitive dividend rate plus matches 10% of your annual account deposits up to $1,000 every year through the age of 17. Open this account as soon as your child is born to reach over $15,000 in savings. by the time they head off to college. It's easy. What a great way to save. Opening a Sprout account online today. That's formcu.com or Kevin and the gang at a Form branch location.
During a normal year, moms do it all. They're superhuman. But this year, moms took on so much more. They kept us safe, kept our hopes up, and kept everyone going. And that's on top of all the other superhuman mom stuff. So this Mother's Day, shop Helzberg Diamonds and make Mother's Day extra special for her. We have a large selection of meaningful gifts for every budget, so our associates can help you find the perfect gift to show how much you truly appreciate her. Visit your local Helzberg store or Helzberg.com. Don't forget your special mom this year, Sunday, May 9th.
There is nothing harder than being a parent right now. So if your house currently sounds like this, you need a break. And surprisingly, donating plasma at BioLife Plasma Services can give you a break. Stay with me here. It's a physical break from the kids. Yes, finally some alone time. Give your bank account a break. You could earn up to $1,000 in your first month. And a break from reality. Free Wi-Fi, baby. So book an appointment today to donate your life-saving plasma. BioLife. There's purpose in your plasma. Visit BioLifePlasma.com to learn more.
We know the month of May is all about racing in our great state, but before we get there, you've got some money to make over on PropSwap. I'm Kevin Bowen, and I can't tell you how much I've loved scouring PropSwap over the past few months. PropSwap is the eBay of sports betting, with props available to buy or sell that have the best odds in the country. Right now, there are gobs of NBA playoff, end-of-season award props available, and even some for the PGA Championship coming up, which, of course, I love. I've also got some great news for you looking to add to your PropSwap account. For any user, not just a new user, any user, you can earn a free deposit bonus up to $100 with the promo code FREE100. Again, that's a free deposit bonus up to $100 with the promo code FREE100. If you're not buying and selling on PropSwap, you are missing out. On average, sellers are making $500 a month. So download the PropSwap app or head to PropSwap.com today.
Carrie Stacey here for the largest Hallmark store in the country, Cynthia's Hallmark, family-owned for 36 years, 4 locations, and with Mother's Day coming up, this is a great time for you to see the incredible selection of gift ideas all under one roof. The deals start when you walk through the doors. Just be sure to grab one of those extra-large sentiment canvas totes for just $6.99 and take 20% off of everything you can fit inside. And the tote bag makes a great gift if you don't end up keeping it for yourself. And then start shopping for Mom. Check out the windowsill grow kits, birdhouses and wreaths made of birdseed, just $14.99. And if you've been looking for the new fun Pirani Life stainless steel tumblers for Mom, Cynthia's has them in every color. Exquisite jewelry like Ronaldo bracelets and necklaces, always a winner. And the very popular vegan leather handbags by Joy Susan. For the biggest selection of Mother's Day gifts, shop Cynthia's Hallmark at 116th and Allisonville Road, 116th and Brook School Road, 96th and Lantern Road in Fishers, and in Greenfield. Stop by today.
When it comes to working at Geico, our best advocates are our employees, like Maxine. But since she is so focused on growing her career, we hired an actor to read her story.
At Geico, I love mentoring the new associates to help them make this a career and not just a job.
And with new opportunities and job stability, Geico has been helping people grow their careers for over 75 years. The only downside, she still hasn't met the gecko. Where are you, fella?
Ready to start your career, Indy? We're hiring claim sales and service agents. Apply online today at geico.job/Indy.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
I want you out in front of the school with her. I'd like to have a few words with you, by God.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
And on a Cinco de Mayo, let's go one margarita from Born Here, Live Here, Die Here. That is Luke Bryan. One margarita. August the 20th, Ruoff Home Mortgage Music Center. Luke Bryan is going to be the Thank You Live Nation. I got to give a shout out, man. I want to see my man Jimi Hendrix sometime. So shout out to Jimmy and to Kyle Johnson over there, too. Shout out to them. I love having Live Nation back on board and giving away tickets. So knock yourself out. District Tap tomorrow. Coors Light with me. Deo Adegbo tomorrow is going to be with us. Second round selection by the Colts. Mike Chappell with us tomorrow as well. Jimmy has phoned at 239-1070 right now. Hello, Jimmy.
Hey, John. How are you, my friend?
I am great, buddy. You got it.
Thanks for sneaking me in and putting in the show. Hey, two things real quick. One, on the Pacers, I agree with you. I think Shams is now the player guy, and Adrian Wojnarowski is the executive guy. But at first I was thinking when I was on hold that Nate is in over his head, but I just think it's too early to get rid of him. I agree with what the last caller was saying, who's been a fan since the ABA days. And I just hope next year will be better and hopefully less injuries. And I'm hoping for the best, obviously, the rest of the year. But even my rose-colored glasses can't see past the play-in series. So one last thing, John. If Kevin Bowen needs an agent, let me know. I'm a big fan of his and of yours as well.
He'll like that. Thank you, buddy. I'll see you tomorrow at District Tap, right?
See you tomorrow, John. Thank you.
That's my man, Jimmy. District Tap tomorrow, Coors Light. I've got Hawks-Pacers tickets for you coming up tomorrow, too. I'm sure the Pacers aren't very happy. Listen, let's find out exactly what's going on, Kevin. Kevin Pritchard, let's find out what's going on. What you got going on tonight? You got Sacto and the Pacers 7:30 pregame show. I think it's Hammer coming up next with the betting show right here. 93.5, 107.5, and 1070 The Fan. District Tap, Coors Light tomorrow at 3.
Today is nonstop. And suddenly, your checking account is overdrawn. But what if we gave you more time on that one? At Huntington, if you accidentally overdraw your account by $50 or less, we've put a $50 safety zone in place, so you won't be charged an overdraft fee. It's one more way we're looking out for you. So you can have time for what matters most. Huntington, welcome. $50 safety zone does not apply to returned items. Your account will be automatically closed if it remains negative for 60 days. Learn more at Huntington.com/safety zone.
Hey, I'm Piper. Here's my deal. I want the best for the least. Right now, Bilista Chevy has 30 pre-owned vehicles priced less than $14,700. Ask for Piper's pre-owned deal to get $3,000 more for your trade. Want something brand new? The Equinox is $7,000 off, and at this price, we can't keep them on the lot. If we don't have exactly what you want, pre-order your Equinox to lock in Piper's price. $7,000 off. $7,000 off and $3,000 more for your trade? Now my deal is your deal at Bill Estes Chevy. I-465 in Michigan Road, the friendliest intersection in Indy.
Bet on more than the final score with One Game Parlay from BetMGM. Hey, it's Big Joe, and One Game Parlay is an exciting feature designed to help you make selections within a single game from over